and Department of Physics.
Welcome, Dr. Sovna.
Please unmute your microphone.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Dr. Sinha sir.
I request all the participants, please keep your microphone on mute mode.
Dr. Gautam?
Sir?
I think Dr. Y. Vimala is in another program. So, we may start, I think.
Okay, sir, if you allow, then Dr. Kavita Sharma, please discuss
with you, sir. Dr. Yadav is here in the office of Professor Y. Vimala. She will join very soon after that program. So, we have to start.
Okay, sir.
Shall we start, sir?
Sure, please.
Okay, sir. तो आप सभी को मेरा सादर नमस्कार. जैसा कि हम सभी जानते हैं कि आज हमारे देश के पूर्व राष्ट्रपति
मैडम आवाज नहीं आ रही आपकी. डॉक्टर कविता मैडम वी कैनॉट हेयर यू.
कविता मैम आप सुन पा रहे हैं हमें?
ओके सी इज कनेक्टिंग अगेन.
ओके सर.
प्रोफेसर वाई विमला विल जॉइन वेरी सून एंड सी अलाउ टू स्टार्ट द प्रोग्राम.
And again, there was some problem in my network, so So I'm starting again. Am I clearly audible? Okay. Thank you. आप सभी को मेरा सादर नमस्कार. जैसा कि हम सभी जानते हैं कि आज हमारे देश के पूर्व राष्ट्रपति महान वैज्ञानिक मिसाइल मैन डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम की जयंती है. इस अवसर पर भौतिकी विभाग चौधरी चरण सिंह विश्वविद्यालय द्वारा इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स रिवॉर्ड्स टू इन्वेंटर्स विषय पर राष्ट्रीय संगोष्ठी का आयोजन किया जा रहा है. इस अवसर पर हमारे साथ हमारे प्रोत्साहन के लिए विश्वविद्यालय की प्रतिकुलपति आदरणीय प्रोफेसर वाई विमला, जो कि एक प्रसिद्ध बोटनिस्ट हैं, वो जल्दी ही हमें ज्वाइन भी करने वाली हैं. वे आज की वेबिनार के मुख्य वक्ता डॉक्टर आर के सिन्हा, हेड CSIR ह्यूमन रिसोर्स डेवलपमेंट सेंटर गाजियाबाद, वे डॉक्टर विनीता जिंदल हमारे साथ उपस्थित हैं. आज हमारे विभाग के संस्थापक प्रोफेसर SP खरे का भी जन्मदिवस है और हमारी खुशी और ज्यादा आज और है क्योंकि हमारे विभाग के शिक्षक डॉक्टर योगेंद्र कुमार गौतम का भी जन्मदिवस आज है. तो प्रोफेसर SP खरे व डॉक्टर गौतम को हम सब ईश्वर से अच्छे स्वास्थ्य व सुखद जीवन की कामना करते हुए वेबिनार को प्रारंभ करने के लिए प्रतिकुलपति मैडम वाई विमला की अनुमति से सर्वप्रथम माँ सरस्वती की वंदना करेंगे. इसके लिए मैं लविस्ता त्यागी, जो कि MSc फोर्थ सेमेस्टर की छात्रा हैं, उनको अनुरोध करती हूँ कि कृपया वो सरस्वती वंदना प्रस्तुत करें. लविस्ता.
थैंक यू मैम. गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू. नाउ आई वुड लाइक टू स्टार्ट द प्रेयर. या कुंदेन्दु तुषार हार धवला, या शुभ्र वस्त्रावृता, या वीणा वरदंड मंडित करा, या श्वेत पद्मासना, या ब्रह्मा ज्योत शंकर प्रभृति, देवै सदा वंदिता, सामां पातु सरस्वती भगवती, निशेष जाड्यापहा. थैंक यू.
धन्यवाद लविस्ता, बहुत अच्छी सिंगिंग आपने की. सॉरी. इस साथ ही मैं डॉक्टर गौतम को रिक्वेस्ट करूंगी कि कृपया वो आगे के कार्यक्रम की बागडोर संभालें. डॉक्टर गौतम.
थैंक यू डॉक्टर कविता मैडम फॉर योर नाइस वर्ड्स एंड बर्थडे विशेस, एंड थैंक यू लविस्ता. नाउ आई रिक्वेस्ट प्रोफेसर वीरपाल सिंह, हेड ऑफ द फिजिक्स डिपार्टमेंट एंड कन्वीनर ऑफ दिस नेशनल वेबिनार, टू इंट्रोड्यूस today event and about the current activities and progress of physics department, and also please give brief introduction our eminent speakers. I request you, sir.
Thank you, Dr. Gautam. I think I am audible to all, and my screen is also visible to all. Please sure. Gautam, I am audible?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
My screen is visible to you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. So, good morning to all present in this national webinar, which Department of Physics is going to organize on the occasion of 89th birth anniversary of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, the missile man, a great scientist of this country. On this occasion, first of all, I should welcome our Honorable Vice Chancellor in absentia, the patron of this webinar, Professor N.K. Taneja, and co-patron of this webinar, Professor Y. Vimala. She will join us very soon. And our keynote speaker, Dr. R.K. Sinha. He is the head of CSIR HRDC. And technology management from New Delhi, organizing secretary of this webinar, my friend, my colleague, Dr. Yogendra Gautam, faculty members of Department of Physics, Dr. Anil Yadav, Professor Anil Malik, Dr. Sanjeev Kumar Sharma, Dr. Anuj, Dr. Kavita, and the faculty members of other departments, as I am seeing, Dr. S.S. Gaurav, Professor Lohni, and many more. And especially, I should mention the name of Dr. Shobhna Chaudhary, who helped us to organize this webinar, to manage, to arrange a keynote speaker, Dr. R.K. Sinha, and dear students and other participants who join this webinar on the very short notice of Physics Department. I welcome you all on this great day, on the 89th birth anniversary of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. In addition to that, as Dr. Kavita mentioned, today is the birthday of our founder head, Professor S.T. Khare, and our young professor, Yogendra Gautam. So I congratulate, I wish happy birthday to Dr. Gautam, Professor Khare, and the great missile man, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. With these words, I welcome you all in this webinar. And although it's an online meeting due to COVID pandemic, I try to make a visit, online visit or virtual visit of our department, as Dr. Gautam mentioned. So through the slide show, I will try to visit you people, the Department of Physics of this university. Before saying something about the Department of Physics, let me say something about our university, Chaudhary Charan Singh University, Meerut. Formerly, it was known as Meerut University. It is the oldest university of this state. It established in 1965. And it is a very beautiful university, which sprawls over more than 220 acres of land. A very lush green campus we have. We have one constituent medical college and one engineering college, SCRIT, with our university. And it's again a matter of proud for us that more than 1,000 aided and professional colleges, institutions, self-finance colleges, government-aided colleges, are affiliated with this university, and at a time more than 7 lakh students regularly study with this university. We have all 8 engineering and technology and law. Which is run under Faculty of Science. In our department, presently we are running MSc 4 semester course with CBCS, and from this year only we have phased out our MPhil program. Although it was very prestigious program of this university, but as per National Education Policy recommendations, we have phased out MPhil program from our university. Our department was also running that program from this before this current year. and it's again a matter of in nanospectral materials, in theoretical atomic Boolean theory, in condensed matter physics, in spectroscopy, in plasma physics and terahertz, and in atmospheric physics. So we really cover number of areas in terms of research conducted by our department. Also, we have a very good research facilities in our department. I have mentioned major equipments which we have in our department. Probably we are the first even in this state that has clean room facility with optical mask wafer align with nano imprint lithography attachment for micro nano imprint lithography. We have SEM, we have scanning tunneling microscope, we have UV visible NIR spectrophotometer, we have Raman spectrophotometer, we have atomic force microscope, we have LabVIEW for virtual laboratory to our student. We have thermal vacuum coating unit. We have very advanced RFDC magneton sputtering system. We have chemical processing facilities. We have superconducting material synthesis lab with high temperature furnace. So I try to visit you virtually to our department in next few slides. As I told you that we have online LabVIEW facility. And we have a library with high speed internet, LAN-WAN facilities. In addition to that, we have, as I told you, all the vacuum coating unit, some furnace and spectrophotometer. These are very few old instruments which we have in our department. But recently, by the DST SIST grant and a number of projects sponsored by DST as well as UGC, we create state-of-art facilities, research facilities in our department. We have scanning tunneling microscope. We have clean room facilities, as I told you. We have class 1000 clean room for micro and nano fabrication facility, which is equipped by optical stepper. We have clean room chemical processing facilities with laminar flow benches equipped with HEPA filter with hot plates and spin coater, etc. We have smart materials and sensor laboratory equipped with a number of equipments for synthesis as well as for characterization application, especially for sensing applications. We have solid state synthesis laboratory, especially for crystal growing, for superconducting materials, equipped with high temperature muffle furnace, evacuation setup, as well as quartz tube sealing equipment in our department. We have very advanced three target RFDC and magnetron sputtering system, which works in RF, DC, and in magnetron mode. And number of students are working on this equipment. They are depositing their material for different solid state device applications using this sputtering system. For characterization, we have the advanced atomic force microscope, which works in different modes, in STM, in FMM, in LFM, in DLFM, in magnetic force microscopy mode, in EFM and in AFM. So it's again a very sophisticated as well as advanced equipment for surface characterization of materials, which is really available in our department. In addition to that, we have a very advanced electron microscope, scanning electron microscope with EDEX detector as well as with the spin coater for making the conducting surface of the dielectric material in our department, which we purchase with the DST SIST grant. We have this important equipment, spectroscopic microscopic equipment, in our department for material characterization. In addition to that, recently our department purchased micro Raman spectrophotometer with DHR CM ICMR funded project, equipped with laser source having 785 nanometer wavelength with CCD detector and with data acquisition software. It's again a very advanced equipment in terms of Raman spectroscopy of materials in our department. So that was all about the virtual tour of Department of Physics, really what we have in our department in terms of research facilities. In addition to that, very soon we are going to establish quantum computational facilities in our department for simulation and all. Very soon, one of our professors is working with that kind of facility, and very soon we also have that kind of facility in our department. Now, as I told you that we are celebrating Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam 89th birth anniversary, and even UNO recently in 20 declare 15 October as a World Student Day. So it's again a matter of proud for our country that even globally, even world recognize this great day, 15 October, and worldwide we are celebrating this day as a World Student Day in the memory of our great Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. So let me say something about this great man. As we are organizing this great event in the memory of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, this is all about the brief biography of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I think everyone knows about the greatness, about the biography of our former president APJ Abdul Kalam, but it's my duty to say something about you, or to show something about this on this great day. As in this particular slide you are seeing that his father was simply a boat owner. So you may simply see from which family he belongs to. He used all the newspapers to supplement his family income. So that was the hard working of Professor Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. And you are seeing even in childhood, he used to do that kind of hard working for his family. After that, as far as his education is concerned, his primary education was from Rameswaram Elementary School. Later on, he studied in which is Matric School, Higher Secondary School, Ramaputram. In 1950, he joined St. Joseph College at Tuchapalli for his BSc degree in physics. It's again a matter of proud for us. He joined BMIT in Aeronautical Engineering at MIT, Madras Institute of Technology. And he did his graduation from this university, from this institute. And after that, he joined HAL Bangalore as a trainee. So that was all about the education of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. After graduating, he joined as a chief scientist at ISRO for satellite launch vehicle program. And from 1992 until 1999, Dr. Kalam was appointed as the chief scientific advisor to the Prime Minister of our country and the secretary of DRDO. It was during this time that Kalam served as the chief project coordinator for Pokhran second nuclear test. We know all well that, after which he was fondly called as the missile man of this country. So missile man of the country, of the India, was really awarded. awarded to this great personality. Major projects, missile projects for Nag, for Prithvi, for Akash, for Trishul, for Agni. So that was the contribution of great APJ Abdul Kalam. He was elected as the 11th President of India in 2002. And again, it's a matter of again proud that the ruling party, BJP, as well as opposition party, unanimously elect 11th President of this country in 2002, Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. And these are few awards Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam received. Number of honorary doctorates from many universities. Padam Vibhushan in 1981, Padam Bhushan in 1981, and Padam Vibhushan in 1990. And India's highest civil honor, the Bharat Ratna in 2013. He was also the recipient of Von Borun Award from National Space Society. These are very few which I mention over here. Number of awards and honor he received during his career. And he again wrote number of books in all, Wings of Fire, autobiography of APJ Abdul Kalam. In addition to that, nowadays, we are now in 2020. So we should remember the book of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, Bharat 2020, Nav Nirman Ki Rooprekha. आज हम देखते हैं जो बातें इस पुस्तक में लिखी हैं उसी का समय है और नॉलेज सुपर पावर इस देश को बनना है ऐसा विजन महान व्यक्तित्व डॉक्टर एपीजे अब्दुल कलाम का रहा है. यू नो अल्टीमेटली ऑन 27 जुलाई 2015 एट द एज ऑफ 83 ही वाज डिलीवरिंग अ लेक्चर एंड ही ब्रीथ्ड द लास्ट. He had the last breathing on that great day, and ultimately he was delivering lecture at that time also. So that was the fact that he was really the karma yogi during his entire life. These are a few famous quotes, number of quotes you have of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. I put very few over here. Forget what hurt you, but never forget what is taught you. And it's a very important quote again. Dreams is not the thing you see in sleep, but it's that thing that doesn't let you sleep. Success is when your signature changes to autograph. So these are very inspiring quotations said by Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam. And he again mentioned for last benchers in the class that the best brain of the nation may be found on the last bench of the classroom. So that was all about the great APJ Abdul Kalam. After that, today's we are organizing a webinar on IPR, and our keynote speaker is our Professor R.K. Sinha. I welcome you, sir. And before handing over mic to Dr. Gautam, let me say something about our keynote speaker, Dr. R.K. Sinha. He is working presently as head CSIR Human Resource Development Center, Ghaziabad. Dr. Sinha obtained his PhD degree in ceramic engineering from IIT Banaras, Hindu University, Varanasi, in 1993, and MSc in Physics from Himachal Pradesh University. He published many research papers in peer-reviewed journals in the area of physics, material science, and science and technology policy. Apart from this, he has published more than 25 institutional reports in different proceedings and all. Dr. Sinha is working for around 26 years in the premier institutions. 7 years in Center Electronics Limited, CEL, a public sector enterprise under Ministry of Science and Technology, 2 years in DRDO, And before moving the position of head CSIR, HRDC, Ghaziabad, he was involved in R&D management at CSIR headquarters. And he execute mega mission mode and fast track transmission projects, fire plant projects, and also monitoring as a member of monitoring committee. These projects have direct relevance to the society in promoting innovative research with new ideas for betterment of the humanity at large. He had not only acted and helped many mega projects of CSIR successfully. In addition to that, he led a team of to technology transfer from DRDO to CEL for production of CD, Z, and T single crystal, a very important ternary material in metal science, but also involved in research for nearly 8 years related to advanced materials. He was also the member convener of review of autonomous bodies like physical science and engineering science cluster in 2017. He was also the member of DSIR. He delivered many talks, invited talks in number of institutions and universities. He was also the representation committee of CSIR for CCS rules, Government of India. He served as secretary, CSIR Sports Promotion Board. I think recently he is working as secretary, CSIR Sports Promotion Board. I have learned from Professor Dr. Somna Chaudhary, member of technical committee and steering committee of Department for Empowerment of Persons for with Disabilities, Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment of Government of India, member technical committee of Indian Council of Medical Research, ICMR, for finalization of agencies for executing expositions and exhibitions for ICMR, member of number of technical committees of ICR and many more, member of assessment committee for technical officers of some CSIR labs, member convener for next generation human research subcommittee of CSIR, and he is also life member of Material Science Society of India and secretary Society of Information Sciences. We mention few credentials of Dr. R.K. Sinha in our slides, but he's contributing more than what I saw in my presentation. So I welcome you, Professor R.K. Sinha, for this webinar, important webinar on IPR. In addition to Dr. R.K. Sinha, we have another expert speaker, Dr. Vinita Jindal. She is the chief manager, intellectual property and technology management, Biotechnology Industry Research Assistance Council, BIRAC, New Delhi. And it's again a matter of proud for us that we have Dr. Vinita with us today. As I learned from Professor Y. Vimala, our Vice Chancellor, that Dr. Vinita is alumnus of our university. He studies in botany department. I welcome you, ma'am, in this important webinar. And on behalf of Department of Physics and entire fraternity of this university, I welcome you in this webinar. Let me say something about Dr. Vinita. Dr. Vinita is working, as I told you, as a chief manager in IP and technology management at the BIRAC. She has completed her doctorate and MPhil degree from this university, from Chaudhary Charan Singh University, Meerut, from Botany Department. She was awarded DST Women Scientific Fellowship in the area of intellectual property rights. She is a registered patent attorney at the Indian Patent Office and registered technology transfer professional, and has over 13 years of experience in IP and technology management. At BIRAC, she mentors the startups, innovators, and students on IPR and technology transfer and commercialization related aspects. She also selected for technology transfer course in 2013, offered under Corona program, which is sponsored by DBT, Government of India, at University of Wisconsin, US. Prior to working in BIRAC, she had experience in different law firms. So on behalf of our department and our university, I welcome our guest speakers, keynote speaker, as well as expert speaker. And I welcome all participants, all academicians, dear students in this webinar. I hope this webinar will certainly be benefit in your academic career. With these words, I hand over mic to organizing secretary of this webinar, Dr. Yogendra Kumar Gautam. Dr. Gautam.
Sir, thank you so much for giving nicely introduction about the department activities, today's event, and our eminent speakers. And I also thank for the warm wishes, your blessings on my birthday, and your support, your motivations. You are lucky to having you as a head of the department. So before starting the keynote lecture, let me make two announcements. So during the talk, first and I mean the keynote lecture and the expert lecture, if all the participants, they have a query, so they can post their questions, put on the chat box. So both experts, please available for this question answer session after the talk. And second thing, during between the first and second talk, we will post a link for the feedback form. So by filling the form, you will fill and you will get the certificate on your Gmail, whatever you filled in that. So there are a few announcements there. So now I request Dr. R.K. Sinha sir for the keynote lecture. And Sinha sir will speak on intellectual property rights, rewards to inventors. I request you, sir, please deliver your lecture.
Yeah, thank you, Dr. Gautam. Professor Taneja is the vice chancellor of this university. I think he's not available today. And then Professor Bimla is a pro VC. And then Professor Birpal Singh is the head of department of physics department of Chaudhary Charan Singh University. Dr. Gautam is the organizing secretary. Dr. Vinita is the co-speaker. All faculty members, my dear students, ladies and gentlemen, and my colleague, Dr. Sobhna. I am really feel privileged to be part of this celebration which we have organized today. And really, I am particularly thankful to Professor Birpal Singh, who has just taken us down the memory lane, right from showing all the facilities of your department. So then I was just going through my younger days of doing MSc and then PhD in material science, all furnaces, clean rooms, and all those kind of thing. And particularly, I was amazed to go through the slides which you have shown for our former president, Dr. Kalam. So there are a number of stories of Dr. Kalam, and which is, in fact, aspiring our kids today, not only in India and abroad also. And as you have mentioned that UN has already decided this 15th October as World Student Day, that's a very, very good thing. So it is a very timely celebration which you had organized today. I'm really thankful to that. And sometime just 2-3 days back, you must be aware that Honorable Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh, Yogi ji, he had just given green signal to have an MOU for CSIR as a knowledge partner with the UP government. And you may be aware that we have 4 labs in Lucknow and this Human Resource Development Center in Ghaziabad. So there are 5 units of the CSIR in UP. So we are particularly, we will be coordinating with the UP government and all technical institutes in new cities. And but other labs also will be participating into that. So I hope to have a lot of future collaborations with your university also. And since Dr. Sobhna is here with us now, and she is a good link between the your university and us. Today's topic is intellectual property rights, and what I have added here, reward to inventors. Usually, people are aware about the intellectual property rights, but sometimes they are not very much, they are aware or they don't know why we should patent. So just I want to tell all the students and faculty members of today's program that if you have IP with you, so it is very, very rewarding. And rewarding not only in the monetary terms, in some other terms also. So I think the organizers has given me 45 minutes of time. So I will try to finish it before 12:30. So if I have to skip some slides, so please don't mind. So I want to keep on the time. Okay. So my the structure of the lecture is this. I will just, since I belong to CSIR, so it's my duty to let you know just briefly about the CSIR. And then I will cover some basics of IPR. So just going through the biodata of Dr. Vimla. So she is an expert and of IP, and then she is a patent attorney also. So I am not that much expert, but I will only cover basics of IPR overall, so that it will benefit not only the physics students, but other faculty members and students also. And then I will slightly cover over the infringement. That's a very, very important thing one should know. And IPR and the Sustainable Development Goals of the UN. So this I may skip because of the paucity of time. And then I will cover finally how university can be aligned with the IP things. So that is important. This is my perspective. Okay. So this is the organization structure of CSIR, we can say. We are part of Government of India, and under Government of India is Ministry of Science and Technology. And we have three departments in Ministry of Science and Technology that is being led by secretaries. So DSIR, that is Department of Scientific and Industrial Research, then Department of Science and Technology, and Department of Biotechnology. So all these three departments are being led by secretary, and they are reporting to Minister of Science and Technology. Under DSIR, we have two autonomous organizations. One is CSIR, and another is CDC, that is Consultancy Development Center. And then we have the two public sector enterprises. One is Central Electronics Limited, which is situated in Ghaziabad itself. And another is National Research Development Council, that is NRDC, that is situated in Delhi. And incidentally, CSIR is led by Director General, who is Dr. Sekhar Mandi is our Director General, and who has a dual charge as the Secretary of DSIR also. So this is a general map. Since CSIR is an autonomous organization, basically it's a registered society. So for which the ex-officio president is Honorable Prime Minister of India, and Vice President is Ministry of Science and Technology. So these posts are ex-officio, and then our Director General is Dr. Sekhar Mandi. We have 37 national laboratories spread across India. As I told you, that four are in Lucknow, and rest are all spread across India. And then we have outreach centers. So these are the 39 outreach centers is associated with the different labs. Not all labs, around 15, 16 labs, these are associated with to carry out the local level activities. And then we have six units. So my unit, this Human Resource Development Center, is one of such units. So these units are associated with the or linked with the headquarters directly. So my reporting is Director General CSIR. So this is all about the CSIR. And basically, you must be knowing that we are the torchbearer of the IP movement in the country since long. I will just give you a brief example. When we have started coming into limelight, when I will cover the slides on infringement. Now see, this is the latest patent scenario in India. And since Dr. Vinita is a patent attorney also, and she is associated with IPO, so she must agree with this. Madam, this data we have taken from the Indian patent office itself. So here you can see the main point which I wanted to cover here. Although IITs together, there are 23 IITs in country nowadays, So all IITs together, they have filed in the last 10 years, 2009 to 2019, this is the data. So they have, you can see that they have filed 3,751 patents, whereas CSIR is number two in the filing, 2,413 patents. And so on, the NIT is then 216 and something like that. But if you see the number of patents granted, all IITs together, they have got only 519 patents granted in the last 10 years. Whereas if you see the CSIR, we have 1917. So out of 24 patent filed, we have granted 1917. So it just it speaks about the quality of patent which we are filing. That means in CSIR, we have, we have a separate department as an intellectual property unit, it is called, but it's a department under CSIR headquarters. So we have scientists there, we have technical officers there. So they, what we do, the patent filed by our CSIR lab that comes to headquarters in our intellectual property division, they go through that, the quality of the patent, and then with the help of patent attorney and all, we file it. So we check, before filing, we check the quality, all the veracity of the patents. That's why we have the number of patents is very high. Now we are going beyond the patent granting. So now patent grants is not a parameter. So patent grant, this looks good that we have 2000 patents with us, but unless it is utilized. So now what we are focusing nowadays in CSIR, we are trying to commercialize it. So as a technology. So a technology can have one patent, can have more than one patent also, or the basket of patents. So we are trying to transfer the technology along with these patents, not only transfer. Now we are focusing on the commercialization and deployment also. So unless the technology has been transferred and that particular company has started commercial production, these patents have no use. So unless that has been commercialized, again, my basic premise here, the reward to inventors, it will not be coming through. So patents sirf rakh lene se hamare paas award nahi milne wala hai. So I will cover how it has been done. So CSIR has the highest number of the patent granted. So this is the patent scenario. So I have just shown you the philosophy of the CSIR regarding patent management and all this thing. We have I would like to inform all the faculty members and the participants here that if you want to file some patent, right? So better you can, we have a unit, like six unit I have told. We have one unit that is called UDIP, U-R-D-I-P, that is situated in Pune. So if you want to file a patent, just send your draft thing to UDIP. So they can tell you what is the scenario where you, whether your patent will be granted and whether you are infringing there or not. So do the analysis. Even when you are trying to submit a project to DST or any other funding agency, please try to get it analyzed by the UDIP. So they will show you that whether this project is worth taking or not, or the patent filing is worth taking or not. So that we do. That's why the quality of and the number of patent grants is high for CSIR. So here, so I will just show you few examples of the reward. Not all, I will just give you two examples. One is monetary, another is non-monetary. So one of the earliest stride by CSIR, you must be all aware that this Indelible Ink, which was developed in 1952 by CSIR. And this was transferred, this technology was transferred to Mysore Paints Company in somewhere in 1952 and all this thing. And this was transferred the technology through NRDC. Basically, the establishment of NRDC was the objective was that all the technologies developed in CSIR will be transferred to the companies, to industries through NRDC. So they charge certain fees and then they transfer. So way back in 1952-53, we have transferred this technology to Mysore Paints Company. And with the term, still we are receiving, although it's very small because 1952 was, the rupee value was very small. So, but we are today also we are getting royalty from them. And this company has exporting this into many countries. So still today we are getting the award. So although the persons who are involved in that research, they are no more here, but as your organization, CSIR is getting royalty on that. So that is the monetary reward which one can. Another, this is the example which shows that reward is not through the monetary thing. You must be aware that in the Andhra Pradesh and Telangana, they're all hard rock areas. And they are basically, they are suffering from the, this is a major societal problem. They were suffering from the, particularly this Nalgonda, this Telanga state and all this thing. Here we have a lab, the National Geophysical Research Institute that is situated in Hyderabad. So we have around 120 acre land here. This is the land. And all this area is a low rainfall, only 600 mm, something like that in yearly they are getting. And excessive use of the groundwater for irrigation. So the whole is this Nalgonda area, they used to have the paddy cultivation. And all of you must be knowing that paddy cultivation requires a lot of water. And then the poor water management as practices also. So it was a huge shortage of the water. So these are the societal problem. So our scientists, what they have done, they we have just gone to our land, that is this 110 acre places. And we have done this electrical resistivity technique. This is the these are the instruments which we have mapped this 110 acre area, and these are the contours we have got. So we have got a very beautiful map of the aquifers. So this is the aquifer. So then we have started digging the wells. So you see this well. So around 26 places on the 110 acre area, we have got this bore wells. And then the nearby villages is going through the pipeline to this overhead tanks to the nearby villages, and we're supplying to the villages. Now the questions comes here. I told you that this is the hard rock area. So once we have drilled this water, so how to replace it? How to recover it? So that is another challenge before us. So again, the same technique we have used in the NGRA. And from that, what we have done, we have delineated the cracks between the hard rocks through this 2D resistivity techniques. And then we have just dig the trenches across this area. And after the rainfall and some artificial this thing, we have got a very good water. So that resulted into 2014, where the water level was 300 feet. 2019, we have got to 85 feet. So I told you some 20 years back, they used to have the paddy cultivation, but because of the scarcity of water, they have switched over to the cotton cultivation. And because of the cotton cultivation, the whole area, the soil was degraded. So they are finding it difficult to have the second crop of the crop and all this thing. So after this, they have gone back to the paddy cultivation. Now you can see this is the Google map of the paddy cultivation, and see the smile on this farmer. So this is the reward. So that's why I told you, if you're working in the science, technology, or wherever, two kinds of rewards you can get. This kind of reward, so you're solving the societal problem, you can enjoy this smile. So scientists are happy with that. The second thing was that the monetary thing. So now coming to the basic, what is the IPR basically? This is the intellectual property. So this is a long sentence. We will not go into line. So it's I want to focus on the, this is the creation of mine, right? For the commercial goodwill, that's why I told you. Once you have patent or whatever intellectual property you have, so it should be used for the business, but that should be the protected by law, because we are governed by the land of law. So we have to govern. So basically it's a creation of mine for the commercial goodwill and protected through the law. So this is the basic definition of the IPR for any person who is the new in this field. So what it is, so basically these are the legal rights which it does from your intellectual activity in the area of either is the industrial or the scientific or academic, literary or artistic fields, right? So these safeguard basically the creators, who the idea has come to their mind, or other producers of the intellectual goods and services, by granting them a certain time limited rights. So every component of the IPR, I will come to the what are the components of IPR. So every component has a definite timeline to have to use that exclusive use by that particular owner of that. So protected IP rights is just like any other property, like your land or your house or your car. So you can just sell it, you can own it, you can put it up for the loan also. So you can just exploit it as a normal property. So basically what, so there are 8 or 9 components of this IPR. So central of all these things is idea to wealth. So idea comes in your mind, or you can say the mind to wealth. So there was a common term sometime given by prominent scientists and technologists that mind to market. So IP is going beyond mind to market. It is going to idea to wealth. So in a way, so the first component is the copyright. Okay, so I will briefly mention this in the next slides. Second is the patent. Third is your trademarks. That is also very, very important. And then industrial design and geographical indications. This is the fifth one. Trade secrets, the design of the integrated circuits, and the protection of plant varieties, which I think Dr. Vinita is expert on that. And then last but not least, that is the traditional knowledge digital library. So CSIR again is the pioneer of that TKDL. I will just come to that slide. Now coming to the copyright, this symbol as a student or as a faculty, everybody must be knowing, because we are keep on publishing papers and all these things. The moment the your paper is accepted in a journal, they give you this symbol. So this is the legal term used to describe the rights that creators have over their literary and artistic work. So this is basically only for your literary and artistic work, or your it includes your whether it's a books or research publications, music, paintings, and so on and so forth. So just for sake of knowledge, the first copyright law enacted in England in 1710. So we can now judge that how old this all concepts are. So these are rights of author and inventors both. Initially, this only the copyright, they were working on that. However, in India, it was introduced in only in 1847, of course, when we are under British rule. So the period of copyright, this is very, very interesting. This is lifetime plus 60 years. So a person who had the copyright of any artistic or research publication or whatever it is, so the whole life they are getting that creation is protected. Even after lifetime, 60 years after that, it is valid. The classic example is the Ramayana serial. So during this lockdown, because of this pandemic, actually it was the catastrophe, or it is the catastrophe for the whole humankind in the earth. But still, it has given a number of opportunities for us to come up like this meeting. So in a very short notice, I had Professor Birpal Singh Sood. That is a very short notice he could have organized, and around 100 participants had joined. So suppose if you have to organize this in person, it's very, very difficult to manage 100 people in your university or anywhere else rather. So it has given us an opportunity to share our thoughts together and all this thing. So I was just giving you the examples, Ramayana. So during this lockdown period, Doordarshan has re-telecasted it, right? So the author, or no, you can say the creator or producer of this Ramayana Sagar, he died some 6-7 years back. So when then Doordarshan started, wanted to start this serial, they have approached the granddaughter of Ramayana Sagar and offered her that this is the royalty which we can offer you, because as per the copyright law, you are entitled for that. But she is so generous, she told that it's fine. And since it was created by my grandfather, I don't need any money. So she refused. So that's why so this is a classic example. Even after the death of the Ramayana Sagar, their family or legal here, they are eligible for the reward, you can say. Second is the patent. This is the most, after copyright, this is the most widely acclaimed IP. And this is basically for any invention. Where copyright was your literal and publications and other things, but patent is exclusively for related to industry. So they have right to decide how and whether the invention can be used by others. So if I have patent on my this, so I have right, I have to tell others how you can use it and how long you can use it. So usually the 20 years is from the date of filing, the period is here. So it is exactly in contrast with the copyright. In copyright, we have the lifetime plus 60 years. Here it is a 20 years from the date of filing. So in essence, patent owner makes technical information about the invention that should be the publicly available. So anybody can use it, but they have to give some fees or some whatever the reward to the inventor. That is the very important thing. And the first recorded in the history of this, first recorded patent, Dr. Vinita, if I'm wrong, you can just stop me here. But what I have gathered and what I am telling, there's a 1421 of the first industrial patent was given to Filippo in Florence. Why I'm saying this is disputed, because sometime back I was in Japan attending some program on IP. And there they have given the first patent was granted to Japan. So that's why I'm not very sure, but all the available literature says that the first patent was in 1421. And that particular person or the group of person, the engineers, they have got a 3-year monopoly on the manufacture of the barts, hosting the gear used to transport the marbles. So you can see that this is the 1421, the first patent. And in India, we can say this is efficient pankha pulling machine. So many of you must be knowing that when the Britishers were here, so at that time there were no AC. So all of our slaves, that Indians, जो हमारे भाई बंधु थे उस समय, उनको use करा देते थे ये लोग पंखा झलने के लिए. Whole day they used to just वो पंखा झलते रहते थे उनको. And उसमें लेकिन कुछ लोग थे, there was one civil engineer. That is Alfred D. Penning. Unko thoda sa theek nahi laga ki yaar is a manual job karte hain. So he has got this efficient pankha pulling machine. To isse jo labor jo kaam karte the unka kafi had tak unka jo mehnat hai wo kam ho gaya tha. So it's not like that all the Britishers were just bad people. There are some good people also. And that's why India has got the first patent, that in 1856. Now there are some basic criteria of this is very important for all the faculty members and the students who are joined today. The first important factor of going for a patent when you are doing some research in your lab or wherever, first you have to check the novelty. It must be novel. It should not be known earlier. Even you must not be knowing, even you, when you are filing a patent. So novelty is the first criterion of having the patent filing. And this is the point where most of the patent filed are rejected. As you have seen in the IIT's case or some other, rejection are the, so many factors are there before the rejection, but this is the one of the major factors, the novelty. There's a lack of novelty. So that is very, very important to ensure when you are going to file a patent. And it should have the inventive step, which is very important that you should have some state of the art technology must be there. Then only they will consider it. And then the industrial applicability, unless it is applicable to an industry, it should not be filed. Although the patent office will reject it, right? So these are the three basic criterion you have to go through that you must consider before patenting. So, and the date of filing is very, very important. But this is more important in the biological thing, drugs and other things, because and the time zone and other thing. So so what I told you that you have to be considered novelty, inventive step, and it should be in, so all keeping all these three factors, then the fourth restriction on your is the date of filing. Suppose two persons are working in the two different countries and on a similar topic and all this, you must be knowing through your literature survey and all these things. So before you, the Japanese fellow or the Korea fellow has filed that. So now they have the right and we have lost our chance. So date of filing is important. So you have to make a balance between the date of filing and all this criteria. Then the trademark. This is the sign capable of distinguishing the goods or services from the other. So this is again has the business angle in it here. And this is very, very old system because they you must have heard about the Picasso's painting and all these things. So they used to put their signature on that. So that also that the signature is, as Professor Birpal Singh had just shown us, the success is that your signature becomes an autograph. So similarly, either for the Picasso, even for the Dr. Kalam, if you signature you on your book, so that is the autograph. So that has become the trademark. So now numerous examples are there. I'm not going into details. You can see all this. So these are all the trademarks. So the basic purpose of trademark is that nobody can copy it, your product and all these things. But the problem is this, sometimes it's very difficult for the common person to distinguish between the trademark, which like Amul has given or the Coca-Cola has given. See the style of the Coca-Cola or the Facebook or the Nivea. And one example, which I have not put here, that is MDH. This is our own MDH masala in India. So if you can go in the market and you can find a number of MDH packets are there, they're all fake. So but that comes under infringement. But once you have got this trademark with you, so you have the brand value. So again, it is going for your business. So the business angle is everywhere in the IP. And then is the industrial design. Again, this is the considered the ornamental or aesthetic aspect of the article. And it may consist of 3D features, such as the shape, surface, or article, or any 2D features or something like that. And these are the taken from the IPO office. I'm not going into details on this. I will just briefly tell you about some of the very famous examples of the world. This is the Mini Cooper. You might be seeing nowadays this car and freely available in India also. So this is basically designed by Alec Sigonis in the Second World War time of the British. So that time the German cars Beetle was a very, very famous. But due to World War, there's a lack, there's a scarcity of the fuel and other things. So Britishers have asked them to design a car which use less fuel. So they have come up with a very small car that is called the Mini Cooper. And it's a very, very successful. But today it is not a cheap car. This comes at a cost in India. And this is the famous Coca-Cola design. This Earl Dean has designed in 1915. There is a story behind this. The proprietors of Coca-Cola, they have asked this Mr. Dean to design a bottle for Coca-Cola. So he was started searching how to design Coca. He tried to coca. Coca is basically, you know, the plant from where they are getting the coca, and the cola is the nut. So from that they were extracting the formula. But they are not able to do that. So what this gentleman has done, they have just suddenly got the coca bud. So coca bud se leke jisse ki ye basically nikalta hai. So this shape is from the coca bud. So 1915 mein inhone design wo kiya, and the basic demand of that person for the Coca-Cola is that even a blind person, if he is holding the bottle, he can distinguish that this is a Coca-Cola bottle. So that was the beauty of that, only to increase their business. So again, the business factor has come. And this scooter, this is the earlier version of the Lambretta scooter. So before the Lambretta, only people have in world, they have only the motorcycles. So motorcycle aur isme dono mein difference ye hai ki isme anybody can go through this. Easily isme hum isko ride kar sakte hain, easily isse hum utar sakte hain, jo ki motorcycle mein nahi hota tha. So they have started using it for the delivering docks during the World War. And then it has become, you know, so everybody knows about the utility of scooters and all. Similarly, this camera there in the Second World War, and this is the iPad. Everybody knows about that. So these are the classic examples of the industrial design with the very, very successful designs. So it has come into, so all these fellow who has designed this, they were not scientists. They were simple artists. And they have come up with this, and this has become so famous. Then geographical indications, everybody knows about that. Anything which is linked to a particular geographical location, like recently you might have heard about the fight between West Bengal government and the Orissa government about the geographical indication of the Rasgulla. So even from my childhood, I used to understand that Rasgulla jo hai ye Bengal ka hi trademark aur wo hona chahiye. Lekin when Orissa government has filed geographical indication, they have got it. So then we come to know about that Rasgulla to Orissa se nikla hai, Bengal se nahi nikla hai. So there are numerous examples of that in India, and at Mysore silk, Mysore sandalwood, and all these things. And here this CSIR has played a role about this Kangra tea. If you have visited Kangra, any of our fellow participant today, आपने देखा होगा कि कांगड़ा में टी प्लांटेशन बहुत ज्यादा होता है, बट टिल सम टाइम बैक इट डजंट हैव एनी ज्योग्राफिकल टैग विद दैट. सो आवर लैब इन पालमपुर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ हिमालयन बायो रिसोर्स टेक्नोलॉजी, दे हैव हेल्प देम टू ऑब्टेन दिस ज्योग्राफिकल इंडिकेशन. सो नाउ यू कैन गेट द कांगड़ा टी इन द मार्केट, एंड द मोमेंट यू गेट द GI टैग, it is very, very important that nobody else can enter into this area. And this all these teas, like Kangra tea or Munna tea, they have the fragrance difference. or the Darjeeling tea. So once you have the Kangra tea, means Kangra tea. So you know the quality. So you can export also. Again, the business has come into that. So that are the rewards coming to them. Now, there are some trade secrets. Again, the details I'm not going to I will just give you two examples. That is KFC and Coca-Cola. KFC has never shared the recipe of the this fried chickens. And if you are non-vegetarian, you must be knowing that what is the difference between the Kentucky fried chicken and the normal fried chicken, which is sold anywhere else. Similarly, in the Coca-Cola, even the Coca-Cola recipe, people used to say that they have only two or three copies and it is kept somewhere in the locker. So nobody knows about this. So if you compare with the taste of the Coca-Cola with the Pepsi and Thumbs Up and whatever it is, you can find a lot of difference in that. So that is trade secret is also very, very important. And they are minting money like anything. So KFC mein jo recipe aap copy kar lijiye nahi hoga copy, but they are minting like anything. So again, business has come into picture. Similarly, integrated circuits, all the persons who are from the physics and electronics, and they must be knowing the importance of the ICs. They said recently integrated, inducted into the patent law. And then the protection of the new plant varieties, I will not must devote any time on that because our expert Dr. Vinita is here to tell you that. I will just devote some time on the traditional knowledge digital library. India and China both have some thousand years of your traditional knowledges, which our grandparents or grandmother and they used to do that. So what CSIR has We have converted into the five international languages in CSIR. English, Japanese, French, and German, and Spanish. So it helps international patent offices not to grant patent if it is known, because the first criteria is a novelty. So if a process is known anywhere in the world, you cannot grant a patent. So this helps us to protect our our traditional knowledge. Now I will take you to the famous case of Haldi. It is in CSIR, it is known as the Haldi Ghati battle also. So and thanks to our former Director General, Dr. R.A. Mashelkar, he has taken this stride. You know what happened in 1995, USPTO has granted patent to two researchers. Incidentally, they were Indians. And the University of Mississippi for wound healing agent, Haldi as a wound healing agent. So the moment this patent has granted, Dr. Mashelkar has approached our patent attorney in the US and they told him, you cannot, because this is it is known in India. Haldi mein, wo doodh mein haldi mila ke peene se chot ka haldi, haddi ka dard kam ho jata hai, ye toh bachpan se hum log sunte aa rahe hain. Unhealing mein tha, toh how you can get grant a patent? So CSIR ne isko contest kiya aur un logon ne, since they were also Indian, our attorney was also Indian, toh fight mein nahi gaye. उन लोगों ने पेटेंट विड्रॉ कर लिया. सो थैंक्स टू सीएसआईआर दिस पेटेंट वाज विड्रॉन इन यूएस. सो स्टिल दिस इज सो यूएसपीटीओ हैज विड्रॉन दिस ग्रांट. अनदर फेमस केस इज नाकामुरा. बीइंग ए फिजिक्स स्टूडेंट यू मे बी नोइंग अबाउट दिस पर्सन. आई विल जस्ट ब्रीफली टेल यू. 1979 नाकामुरा ज्वाइन निशिया कॉर्पोरेशन एंड इन 1980 ही स्टार्टेड वर्किंग द ब्लू एलईडी. दैट up to that time blue LED was not there, and within 1993 he got a patent, but that time the patent was granted to the again here our expert Dr. Vinita can tell, the patent rights varies from country to country. In India, if you are working in any institution, so institutions have the prime right, not the individual. But in Japan, individual have the prime right. So but since he was working in the NISIA, NISIA Corporation, so the profit was estimated for 120 billion yen. That converts another $1 billion. But he got $200 as a special reward. By that time, he moved to US to some university. But he has filed a case. This was my this thing, and as per the Japanese rule, this I must be get the award on that. So the Japanese he won the case and he got around $7 million in that. But again, he was a very, very patriotic person, so he didn't take this money. of course it gone into the Supreme Court and other thing. So but ultimately he didn't claim any money in that. So because he told ki Japan ka paisa Japan mein rehna chahiye. I don't want any money, but I just wanted to tell Nisia and other innovators that this is my right. I should be granted. You know, just see the value reward $200 and $7 million. So huge amount. So now this I will skip because I'm running out of time. So I will just come to this is important thing. This I wanted to tell you, sir, all participants here, that every country has a national, must have the national innovation system, and not only have, it should have the very, very effective national innovation system if we want to be a world leader, or any country want to be a world leader. And thanks to our governments, we have a very, very effective national innovation system in place, where every these are the various players of the NIS, National Innovation System. Local governance, R&D institutes like CSIR, finance institutes, any finance institute like funding agencies it includes. Then you should have the market, local industries, and the academia. All these six players, see, this is the intermingled. Absolutely, this is all interlinked. And they are doing their own work. Academia has their own piece of work. R&D institutes have their own piece of work. Industry has own piece of work. But unless they all work in tandem, all or some of them, you are not going anywhere. So national innovation system ko effective banane ke liye, everybody should have played their role very effectively. So academia, that industry, and R&D institutes, primarily these are the prime factors. And then you must have the industry with you, and you must have the local governance and the market, and the, all the policies should be in the place. Now for universities, see, universities and more or less public R&D institutions, they are the factories of the knowledge economy. So basically you are the knowledge generators. All your MSc students, or even the BSc students, or the engineering students, or the medical students, knowledge is generated there in the university. And this is generated in the institution an immense economic and societal benefit. So a robust IP policy, I'm not very much sure about the CCS university, but I hope that you must have your very good, robust IP policy. And if it is not, please consult Indian Patent Office and other attorneys, and you must have the very, very robust IP policy in place in the university. Then what you can do, so select research themes like that is consistent with the industry demand. Just don't go for the sake of publications. Of course, it is easier said than done, but mostly you should try what is the industrial demand, or what R&D policy of the country is demanding. Like very soon we are going to have a fifth or seventh, I think, the STI policy. This is 2020 is going to be released very soon. So please read that and select your research project according to that. Then generate IP, exploit this technological information, excavate the invention, and then establish rights. This is very, very important. Establish the rights for that. And then get advice to the researchers from point of view of the IP. So it is the duty of all the senior faculties that to keep aware them that your research project should be like that. Of course, basic research has its own importance. There's no denial in that. But the IP generation is also very important. So you have to weigh whether your research work or your new work, is it worth for publications? Because publications mein hota kya hai ki sir ye bahut jaldi ho jata hai, we get the reward also immediately ki publication ho gaya, thesis ho jayega, promotion ho jayega. Lekin agar thoda sa wait karke usko aur aap dekhte hain, and if you have the potential, please go for the patent. Once you have get the patent, then only others will not come into that. So, and this is the nutshell slide which I wanted to tell you. There are on the left side, these are the parameters. And if I compare, this we call the university, industry, and R&D institution. If you keep together, these are the three vortices of a equilateral triangle. So everybody has its own role. So, but the only problem with this, if university wants to work in isolation, so they have, of course, Professor Birpal Singh has shown the equipment list and the facility and all this thing, but still the capital is not so good in compared to industry or in compared to the R&D institution. Then again, the market, this is the basic problem with the universities. You don't have the market, which industries has them, because the industry directly related to the market, and R&D, more or less R&D institutions have also the market because they are directly working with the industry like CSIR. But when we compare the research potential, you have the full research potential with you. Universities are, I mean, nobody can compare the university and academic institutions, the research potential is there. Industry, it is almost nil. Some industries, all, of course, they have, but almost not in comparison to university. I'm telling all these figures in the comparison. It's not like that industry doesn't have any R&D, but if you compare with the university, they are negligible. Similarly, for R&D institutions, we have the research potential. And if you see the R&D institutions, we have all three. We have the capital, we have the market, we have the research potential. But unless we, but the knowledge generators, sometimes we don't have with us. So we have to collaborate with you. So in a nutshell, all these three have to come together. Then only we can play a very effective role in the national innovation system. So these are the things. And as I told in my opening remark that we are going to have the knowledge partner with the UP government. So this collaboration through CCS University or through other universities also, we are open to have this kind of collaboration. So that ultimate goal is that to serve our industry and to I will share this presentation with you also. So how you can exploit, what are the advantages of exploiting your rights? Second is very important, prevents latecomers through defensive applications. If you have filed, even you think that it is going to be rejected or something like, just file it. File karne se kya hoga ki dusre log jo aane hain unko time lagega kyunki aapne pehle file kar diya hai. Reject ho jayega to baad mein dekhenge. So in that way, IT's strategy is also okay. But it is not good for the industry perspective. Then partnering through the cross license organizations and collaborate through the joint research. This is very important. Where I was with you. Okay. So then it should be the economic brief. So in the last, I want to say this: we should have our country has the very very focused IP policy. Creative India, Innovative India. जो हिंदी में अगर हम इसको देखें तो रचनात्मक भारत और अभिनव भारत. तो ये अगर हम अपने दिमाग में लेकर के चलेंगे तो एज ए रिसर्च स्टूडेंट, एज ए फैकल्टी, एज ए साइंटिस्ट इन रिसर्च ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस, वी हैव टू कीप दिस इन आवर माइंड. सो ऑल द टाइम दिस शुड बी द मंत्रा फॉर अस, देन ओनली कंट्री विल प्रोग्रेस. सो थैंक यू वेरी मच सर, एंड आई होप दैट आई हैव कंप्लीटेड ऑन टाइम. And I'll just stop sharing this.
Thank you very much, sir.
You, Dr. Gautam. Yeah.
Sir, you very well explained the various policies and technical points of intellectual property rights. And especially you highlighted the filing of patents and also highlighted some IPR related to the recipe of the KFC and also the future innovations like LED. Thank you so much, sir. And I'm sure this very informative talk will be very beneficial to our participants, professors, as well as students. Thank you so much for sir giving time and very informative lecture. Thank you so much, sir. So in this national workshop webinar, we have our respected professors in this seminar. I must welcome Professor A.K. Chaube sir, Department of Geology, CCS University, Meerut. I welcome you, sir. Professor Pavan Kumar Sharma, Head of the Department Political Science, Chaudhary Charan Singh Vishwavidyalaya, Meerut. Dr. Jamal Siddiqui, sir, Librarian of Chaudhary Charan Singh Vishwavidyalaya, Meerut. Dr. Upadesh Verma, Mananiya Kashiram Government Degree College, Ghaziabad. I welcome you, sir. Professor A.K. Sharma, Jammu University. Professor M.K. Jain, Professor Garima Jain from Samli. Professor Jaiswal, sir, Department of Education, Chaudhary Charan Singh University, Meerut. And we have our sport officer, Dr. Gulab Singh. We welcome you, sir. Thanks for joining this event. And now I request Dr. Vinita Jindal for your lecture. So, Dr. Vinita Jindal, I request you, please deliver your lecture.
Thank you, Dr. Gautam. Can you please allow me to share the screen?
Yes, ma'am, please. Are you co-host?
I'm not sure because this particular option is not permitting me to share the screen.
Yes, Dr. Upadesh, sir, please allow, may co-host Dr. Kavita, Vinita Jindal, sorry. Dr. Vinita, madam. Dr. Upadesh, sir. Professor Malik, sir.
Hello.
Malik sir, I request you please make co-host Dr. Vinita Jindal, our respected speaker.
I think Dr. Yadav can do that. He is already host.
Dr. Yadav, sir.
अच्छा host बना रखा ना Vinita Jindal madam को बना दो.
Now the host is Dr. Upadesh Sharma ji host. I think he
बना रहे बना रहे.
Thank you.
Yes.
मैडम इज नॉट हियर. आई एम यूजिंग दैट लॉग इन पासवर्ड. दैट्स व्हाई इट्स
I am here since beginning.
Yes,
ma'am. Ah, okay.
ठीक है बना रहे हैं.
So, Dr. Gautam, shall I start?
Yes, ma'am. Please, ma'am.
Okay. Thank you, Dr. Gautam. So, good afternoon, everyone. And first of all, before starting the session, I would like to place my thanks to Professor N.K. Taneja, who is the Vice Chancellor of the University, Professor Y. Vimla. She is the Pro Vice Chancellor of the University, and of course, my PhD guide, and Professor Birpal Singh and Dr. Y.K. Gautam, giving the opportunity. And I'm really, very glad to be a part of this webinar. And of course, I would like to thank Dr. Sinha also, who has already covered the basics of the IPR. So my let me, quickly go through some of the slides might be overlapping with the Dr. Sinha's presentation, but I will quickly go through them, and then we will discuss about the patent search and the patent filing process. So today's session is what is the patent, what are the non-patentable subject matters, how to search a patent application. How this whole process actually starts. So Dr. Sinha actually mentioned about the 2 to 3 minutes on this particular slide, where we would discuss and understand the whole innovation cycle and how it actually starts. So any innovator, any student, or maybe any scientist, if they think about anything, so these thinking, this thought process is the process of ideation. So when you ideate something, you discuss about the technology, you discuss about how it can be done. So whole process of the innovation cycle starts from the ideation process, and within this ideation process, you get to know about what should be discussed with the other people, because ideation, if you want to implement the ideation, how support from the others. So others could be your PhD students, or maybe postdoc students, or any other departmental scientist who is actually contributing for this ideation process. So what happens when you ideate, you come up with some solution. You identify the problem. So with this solution, problem solving approach, there are different things. You come up with a novel solution where you think about the intangible assets, and these intangible assets are the intellectual property rights. And you should be aware of how much it should be disclosed to the other people, and how much, what should be taken as a confidential part of this. So that's why intellectual property is the most valuable asset for a, technology startup, for the scientist. And protecting this intellectual property is essential to obtain, Dr. Sinha covered different, advantages or rewards the inventor get while protecting these IPR. So one of the crucial advantages, you get the funding for the innovation or for your ideation, which you have come up during this ideation cycle. So this has already been covered, but I will quickly go through it. So what is intellectual property? So intellectual property protects, basically it is a creation of the mind or the human intellect. And this human intellect or creation of mind could be anything. It could be an invention. It could be any literary and artistic work, design, symbol. It could be any logo, images. And Dr. Sinha has already explained about artistic work and literary can be covered under copyright. Design, we have a provision for industrial design protection. Symbol, names, and images can, they are part of the trademark. So as a creator or whatever you have developed, as a creator, you get an exclusive right over the use of whatever you have created for a certain period of time, because this is all limited with the time. And creation of mind, which should be novel or new and original in the global context. We will discuss the novel part and originality in the subsequent slides. So when we think about the property, so what we think about the ownership, and you all know any property, or if I have a property, I own this property cannot be used without my consent. So that means it requires permission. Same thing happens with the intellectual property rights, because these are the exclusive rights given by the government and awarded based on certain laws. So what happens if I own any intellectual property right, then a permission is required from the owner to use their property. So what are the different nature of these IPR? So it is applicable to all forms of the intellectual property rights, whether it is patent, copyright, design, or trademark. So they are generally time bound. They are territorial. Territorial means if you protect, if you have ownership in one country, you have to file, you have to protect your interests in other countries by filing a different application. So it doesn't mean if you file in India, it gives you a global right. So that's why all IPR are territorial. As I mentioned, they should be original, novel, and it should have a application. And once you file in more than one jurisdiction, it allows you to have ownership in more than one jurisdiction. So let's talk about the patent. So what is patent? This again was covered by Dr. Sinha's his presentation. So patent is a set of exclusive rights. So exclusive right means it is actually granted to any individual. It could be given to any companies, group of individuals, scientists. So what happens when you have such rights available with you? You prevent others from making, using, selling, importing, or distributing a patented invention without their permission. So that means permission is required. They are granted for a limited period of time. So patent, what is the duration of the patent? It is the 20 years from the date of filing to the patent holder by the government. So Dr. Sinha mentioned about date of filing is very important. Why it is important? Because it first thing is it allows you. So 20 years is actually counted from the date of filing. If date of filing, it also has more advantages because, say for example, within your department, if other scientist comes to know or any other person comes to know this work has been done, but he did not apply for the patent. But the other scientist or other person has filed a patent application, and then you file a patent application, it becomes a very problematic thing in the sense the other person will get the priority. So date of filing is very important. Date of, it gives you a right to acquire. So as soon as you have some ideation, as soon as you have developed a technology, you go for the patent filing. And in return, as a patent holder, what I am supposed to do, I have to disclose the invention to the public. So earlier I mentioned about patent rights are territorial. Patent granted in one country is valid in that particular country only. So as a patent owner, there are different rights which I will be having. I have a right to decide who may or may not use the patented invention, and for the duration for which, for the specific time duration, because it is granted for the 20 years. So within that time limit, I have a right to decide who may or may not use. As a patent owner, I may give permission to or license to other parties to use inventions on mutually agreed terms. So Dr. Sinha mentioned about licensing of several technologies which were taken up by CSIR through NRDC. So this is one of the important thing. As a patent owner, you can license out your technologies to the companies. And as a patent owner, you may also sell your invention rights to someone else. So selling means you are transferring your rights, you are selling your rights to someone else. So the other person will become the owner. And the important thing which should be keep in mind that once a patent expires means as soon as it completes its 20 years of time limit, protection ends and the invention enters the public domain. So it will be available for the public, so they can freely use it. That time they don't need any permission or license. So what are the different scopes of patentability under the Indian Patent Act? So there are different basic criteria of patentability, and Dr. Sinha has already covered about the novelty, inventive step, and industrial application. The other important criteria, which is the enablement and best mode. So let me go very quickly into each one of them. So before discussing about the novelty and inventive step, there should be a clarity what is an invention. So invention is basically a new product which you developed, or it could be a new process. And whatever, if it is a product or it is a process, it always has some technical features, technical aspects. And the other important thing is it should be used, or it should has some use in the industrial applications. So these are the two important component: inventive step and capable of industrial application. So novelty means new, and when we discuss novelty in Indian context, it includes invention must not be published in India or elsewhere. So elsewhere means around the world. Invention must not be in prior public knowledge or prior public use within India or elsewhere in the world. So we are talking about the global aspects. So we cover all the public knowledge or public use related to the technology for which I want to file a patent application. So I have to consider these aspects before saying that this is my technology is going to be a novel. And the third point is claimed in any claims in any prior specification filed in India. It means that if someone has filed a patent application, and I also, you know, want to file a patent application, so I have to check. So how this checking is done, I will be explaining in the subsequent slides. So you have to check whether any patent application, whether, you know, it is disclosing such kind of, you know, technology or process which I want to cover. So inventive step, as I mentioned, this is a feature of an invention. It means that it is the technical advancement. So technical features as compared to the existing knowledge. So knowledge is always there. What we are doing, we are improvising on that. So it should have some technical advancements to make it better, to make it more inventive. It should have economic significance or both. And the inventive step should not make the invention, I mean, it makes the invention not obvious to a person skilled in the art. It means that it should not be so obvious, so general that the person who knows the subject can come up with the solution, which I am proposing. Industrial application means, yes, whatever the product process I have developed, it should have a utility. It should be used in should be used by any industry, and usefulness in any kind of industry. So the other important thing is the disclosure enablement and best mode. So what is the disclosure enablement, and how the best mode should be defined? So when we submit a patent document to the patent office, it should define. So like when we, you know, prepare a manuscript for publishing any article in a journal. So what we actually covers, we give the introduction, we give a, you know, conclusion part, we in between, we give the methods, materials and methods. So similarly, in the patent document, there is a, you know, a set format under which set headings are there, under which we have to give all the information, field of invention, background of the invention, what are the advantages, what are the examples. So those points should be, you know, should be defined in a clear way, very concisely. That is taken as a best method or best mode of performing the invention. It means like you are explaining things very precisely, very clearly, so that a person can practice the invention. And it should fully and particularly describe the invention, its operation of use, and method by which it is to be performed. So as per the as per the Indian Patent Act, if we want to discuss like what can be patented, so patent, we know patent protects the inventions, the technical aspects, which solves the technical problems. So it could be like under patent, we can protect chemical substances, pharmaceuticals related products, any process, method. If we have a medical device, system, products, that can also be a part of the patent. And we have already discussed about like it should be new, inventive, and it should have a industrial application. The other important thing is, in most of the countries, including India, patents are not granted for business methods or rules of games or for method of treatment, diagnostics, surgery on the human or animal body. So these are the few exclusions within the Indian Patent Act, which for which the patent cannot be filed. So this slide is basically, you know, targeted towards the life science sector. Within the life science sector, there are few provisions which has been mentioned under the Indian Patent Act, under the Section 3, which defines what is not an invention. So if any invention which is, you know, not which is contrary to the public order and morality, you cannot file. You will not get a patent for that. So that becomes a non-patentable subject matter. Similarly, if you discover something, discovery of living things, it is not allowed. New forms of a known substance, it is not allowed. if you just mix something and you come up with different formulation and you say that this is the formulation or the composition I want to file a patent, you will not get it. You have to give more and more information. What are the technical advantages of getting this mixture? Then there is a possibility you might get it. Method of treatment of animals and humans, you will not get it. Again, plants, animals, their parts thereof, and essentially biological process, we will not get a patent in India. And of course, traditional knowledge, we will not get a patent for it. So I will skip this. And so let's understand the patenting process. So how it, I think someone's mic is on. Within this, how the patenting process,
Gold का area तो इसमें 21 centimeter दे रखा है और हर में इतने दबाव बढ़ते हैं।
Switch off your microphone, Monica. Monica, क्या सुन पा रहे हैं हमें?
क्या find करना है? Area क्या देंगे?
I request Dr. Upadesh sir, please. Mute Monica. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am, please.
Thank you. So within the university system, how the patenting process actually happens? So you have idea, or you have a technology or process which you have developed in your lab. So what happens within the university system, there are different departments, which is known as intellectual property and technology transfer offices. They actually select the idea or the technology or process for which a patent application can be filed. And what they do, so what is the role of these departments within the university is to carry out the patentability analysis, novelty search, and drafting of the patent application. And once they are clear on the novelty aspects and they draft the patent application, the application is submitted to the IP office, intellectual property office. And when you file a patent application, so what are the different roles of the IP office they play during this process? They publish the patent application, they examine the patent application. And if they find they are satisfied with the responses from the patent draft, they actually grant a patent to the inventor, to the university. And like other properties, you also have to maintain this property also. And what you have to do to maintain the property, you have to pay the maintenance fees. So this is the patenting process in a snapshot. As I mentioned, within the second step, where you can it is the novelty search and the analysis and drafting of the patent application. So how we identify or how we assess the novelty part of any technology. So for this, we have to carry out the patent search. It is known as a patentability search or that is made available to the public in any form, and this form could be anything. It could be knowledge, this information could be present in the form of like patent, scientific literature, publication, and publication could be a journal articles, proceedings of conferences, data books, display information, posters, which we actually go for the technical exhibitions, public discussions, or any newspaper articles, and because we discuss about elsewhere, so anywhere in the world, so within India as well as anywhere in the world. So this could be, so this is actually a prior art. So we have to understand what are the prior arts available before filing a patent application. And these prior arts are basically found out with the help of the patent search. So again, within this, you know, when we do the prior art search, there are different purposes. Why we are doing the prior art search or the patent search? Because we want to check whether my invention is patentable, whether I can file a patent application or not. Can I launch a product in any market? So it means before product launch, I have to do a prior art search or the patentability search. During opposition and or revocation process, that's a a different thing. When I want to oppose or when I want to revoke the patent patents of any other institute or the companies. Before planning R&D activities, so before I start my research and development activities, what we do prepare a kind of synopsis. So similarly, we do a patent search to know who are the active players, who are the existing players working in this particular area. So we have to be very clear on the purpose of prior art search. And based on this purpose, so as soon as we are clear why we are searching, it has been termed as patentability search, freedom to operate search, validity invalidity search, state of the art search, and technology landscape. So I'm not going deep into each of them, but let me give you how it is being done. So first of all, what we do, we understand the invention. We identify the keywords from the invention, from the technology, and based on that, we carry out a keyword search. And within the patent system, there are some coding has been done, and which is known as the classification search. So based on these codes, some classification has been provided. If you know the classification, you can do it with the help of classification search. If you know the name of the inventor who has filed a patent application or who has published his article, then you can search with the name of the inventor or with the name of the company or with the name of the university. So when once you have done the searching part, you shortlist the references. And based on that, what you do, you identify the important or relevant patents which are overlapping with your technology. And NPL search, if you can see on your right hand side, NPL search is non-patent literature search. Non-patent literature search means where patent is not going to be patented. It could be scientific journals, articles, newspaper articles, or any other information. So this is the how we do the search. And non-patent literature, you can think about product journals, white papers, data sheets, research papers, dictionaries, encyclopedia, video, articles, books. So these could be a non-patent literature sources. So how we actually perform this search, especially the patent databases, we do it with the help of the patent database. So like what we do, if we want to search anything, we always take the help of the Google and we type whatever we want to identify or we want to search on the Google. So we give a keyword, say for example, mobile phone or Samsung mobile phone. So as soon as we give this keyword, we get some references. Samsung mobile phone, and then we further narrow down with the help of the model number. Similarly, when we do the patent search on the patent databases, we start with the broader search and then we keep narrowing it to get the relevant information. So what are the patent databases? Patent databases are the collection of patents or the applications. And these are basically maintained by the national patent offices. So we will look into it, how, what are the different, you know, sites available where the patent applications can be searched. And some of the databases are, you know, available free of cost. And there are a number of databases which can be subscribed based on, you know, some after paying some amount to the vendors. And these are the Derwent Innovation QPAD, which are normally, you know, being used to search the patent applications. So let's, you know, see which are the freely available patent search where you can just try out any, you know, if you want to have a feel how it looks like. So these are the few URLs I have provided here. You can search on this. If you want to search a US patent document, whether it is granted or published, with the help of US PTO website, you can search the application. Similarly, for the European patent application, if you want to have any information, for the EPO is eSpaceNet. The other database is WIPO, World Intellectual Property Organization, under the patent scope, where you can identify, you can see the patent applications. Patent Lands is another freely available website. Google Patents, Indian Patent Office website. So how it looks like? So this is a snapshot of the United States Patent Trademark Office. You can see three fragments. So on your left-hand side, one column is for the granted patents, and under which you can notice three options: quick search, advanced search, and number search. So if you know the number of the patent, you can always take the help of the number search. If you know the name of the inventor or, you know, name of the company, you can always take the help of quick search and advanced search. Similarly for the application part, on the right hand side, if you can see, there are again three options: quick search, advanced search, and number search. So these are the different, you know, fields available which can be searched on USPTO website. Similarly, on eSpaceNet, you can search the patent application. Again, there are different options: quick search, advanced search, and number search. If you have if you know the name of the scientist, you can always do the advanced search or the quick search. If you know the chemical structure, you have come up with you have a compound, if you want to file a patent application, how it can be filed, whether this particular compound has novelty or not. So you can draw your molecule structure on this ChemSpider database, and you can, you will get a list of the patent documents which might be covering this particular molecule, and you will get to know the novelty part of it. Similarly, for the sequence search, we always use the BLAST, but so it also gives you details of the patent applications or the patents which might be covering these sequences which you have put under the BLAST option. So these are the paid patent databases which you can subscribe depending on the need of the, you know, how much information you want. So coming to the next part of it, which is the once you have done the patentability search, you are fine with the patentability search report, it gives you a go ahead for the filing a patent application. So how you can file? So if you want to own a patent, if you want to have a granted patent, then there are three steps which you have to fulfill. One is the who can file a patent application, where to file a patent application, and how to file a patent application. So just to address all the components, who can file a patent application? Of course, any inventor, the university, institute, company can file a patent application. And where you can file, depending on the jurisdiction. So like UP is, there are four different jurisdictions they have divided. So four patent offices in India, depending upon the principal place of business of applicant or the agent. So if you are located, you know, in Haryana, then you can select, you have to select the Delhi. But if you are a part of, you are residing in the Gujarat or Madhya Pradesh, then you have to opt the Mumbai patent office to file a patent application. So you are in Uttar Pradesh, then you have to select a Delhi. You have to file your patent application at Delhi, Indian Patent Office at Delhi. So how to file a patent application? So you so there are different documents. One is the patent document which you draft. It has to be filed along with different forms. Where you, so one form includes the details of the inventor who have developed the technology. You have to give the information on those aspects. Who is going to own this patent application? So like as a scientist, I am working in the university. So university, it depends on the policy of the university. If generally university will own the patent application, and because I have developed this technology, so I'll be taken as an inventor of the technology. So these kind of details you have to submit while filing a patent application. And you also have to pay official fees while filing a patent application. And you have to keep the track on number of pages, how much, you know, how many pages you are providing within the patent document. And if you are filing as an individual, then there will be a different fee for filing as a natural person. If you are a legal entity, means if you are a university, institute, or a company, then it has to be a different fee. So just to give you a snapshot on procedure, what are the different steps, you know, before granting a patent application in India. So let's understand this. You file a patent application to the Indian Patent Office. What happens? So within 18 months, they published the Indian Patent Office published the application. And so these are the different timelines. And these are quietly, you know, I mean, generally, they are strictly followed. And within these timelines, it has to be done. The request for examination has to be filed by the university or by the inventor or who has filed the patent application. Patent office itself will not examine the patent application. So if I have filed a patent application, I have to request the patent office to examine my application. And based on that, they will give me few set of questions. And if all the objections, if all the questions are responded by me, they grant a patent to the university or to the inventor. And within India, we have two provisions to, you know, get the opposition from the third party. So one is the pre-grant opposition. Pre means before granting a patent application. Post-grant means after grant of the patent. So within these two concepts, pre-grant and post-grant, there is a possibility if any third party can file a opposition for my patent application. So these are the different proceedings, but in a normal situation, if everything is, you know, if all the responses are good enough to satisfy, to, you know, justify the response of the report which has been issued by the patent office, they grant a patent, they can grant a patent. So already Dr. Sinha has covered, you know, most different examples, how, you know, intellectual property is rewarding or awarding to the different companies or the innovators. So let me quickly give you few of the examples. One is definitely Coca-Cola, because they have registered, you know, different trademarks. And if I, you know, if I mention based on, you know, valuation of these trademarks, valuation of, you know, of the customer experience. And this is actually a bit old data, but it in 2013, it was estimated that they are earning and they have, you know, revenue or value of these brands up to like US$79.2 billion. Similarly, Kodak company, and we all know how it, you know, there was a, you know, one case against this. So in 1991, Kodak actually had to pay US$925 million to Polaroid, because they illegally used their Polaroid patented inventions for their camera. So this is the thing. If you own a patent, if other company is, you know, using without your permission, you have to end up in such situations where you might be paying this much of amount, or they might be filing a infringement cases against you. So you have to be very careful while filing a patent application before launching a product in the market. Similarly, in 1991, biotech company Cetus Corporation, they sold their right to the PCR patents for the DNA copying process to Roche for $300 million. So this is the, again, a different example where you can get the reward. If you have a patent, you can sell out your invention to third party or any company. Another example is Nestle. We know that Nestle is one of the leading brand, and if you can see within their logo, they have evolved so much. They started protecting their logo with the help of trademark in 1868 somewhere, and after that they are keep on improvising on their logo design, and they are filing a trademark applications or for the technical parts and for the technical components or inventions. They are filing different patents. So if we can see 300 plus strategic brands, they are protected by around 75,000 trademark registrations in different countries. Similarly, for the local brands, they have filed 6,000 local brands protected by 28,000 trademark registrations. And if we look for the patent, 9,000 plus granted patents covering countries on every continent, and they also have 6,000 plus pending patents. So this is another example of having a valuable invention which is very well protected with the help of patent and trademark. So just to give you one more example on this pasteurization process, we all know it was developed by Louis Pasteur, and he patented his new yeast making method. And now whatever orange juices we get it, every orange juice company, they are using his patented technology to bring the orange juice to our table. Pen with a scanner, what is this all about? This is a machine as small as a pen where you can transfer text from paper directly into a computer. So this is the technology which we use for our screening or screening the mark sheets, or where we fill out, we have the OCR, sheets where we fill out our answers. So this was developed by Krister. He invented the C-Pen, and it has a camera technology and an in-system optical character recognition software. So with the help of this software and the camera technology, it captures and processes the printed text to the computer. So this is all about, just to give you a very brief on the patent searching, on how, and as well as on how to file a patent application. And thank you so much for this opportunity, and I would be happy to take questions if there are any. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Vinita, madam. You delivered a very well lecture, very useful, very informative. And this lecture was full of knowledge, and I can say it's kind of training session also. तो आपने अपने इस व्याख्यान में पेटेंट से जुड़े हुए जो सारी महत्वपूर्ण बातें हैं, चाहे वो पेटेंट सर्च करने पे हो, पेटेंट फाइल करने के लिए हो, ग्रांट फॉर पेटेंट, एप्लीकेशन ऑफ पेटेंट, तो मैं ऐसा मानता हूँ कि जब भी हमारे पार्टिसिपेंट, हमारे साथी शिक्षक और विद्यार्थीगण पेटेंट फाइल या सर्च करने के लिए अपने कदम बढ़ाएंगे, तो ये सेशन बड़ा उपयोगी होगा, ऐसा मैं मानता हूँ। बहुत ही अच्छा आपने व्याख्यान दिया है, और डॉक्टर सिन्हा सर ने भी बहुत सारी ऐसी बातें बताई हैं, तो आप दोनों स्पीकर्स ने मिलके बहुत सारी बातें हमें इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी राइट्स, पेटेंट फाइलिंग बहुत विस्तार से हमें बताया है, जो बहुत महत्वपूर्ण और बहुत उपयोगी साबित होगा। मैं अब जो पार्टिसिपेंट हैं हमारे, उनसे आग्रह करता हूं कि वो अपनी क्वेरी क्वेश्चंस चैट बॉक्स में पोस्ट करें और हम एक एक करके प्रश्न मैडम से उनका उत्तर और सर से उनका उत्तर लेंगे। कुछ प्रश्न आए हैं, मैं एक बार चैट बॉक्स में पढ़ता हूँ।
डॉक्टर गौतम जी प्लीज अभी ना आप फीडबैक लिंक जो आपको सेंड करा था वो भी सेंड कर दीजिए, तो जो भी पार्टिसिपेंट है ना वो भरते रहेंगे अपना।
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल ठीक है, शेयर कर दीजिएगा।
सर मैंने फीडबैक लिंक शेयर कर दिया है। हाँ। आप सब पार्टिसिपेंट से रिक्वेस्ट है कि आप फीडबैक जो लिंक दिया है उसमें अपना फॉर्म भरे। और ये भी मैं आपको जानकारी दे दूं कि जो ऑर्गेनाइजिंग कमेटी है उनका ऐसा आदेश है कि ये ज्यादा से ज्यादा 10-15 मिनट ओपन रहेगा, तो आप व्याख्यान सुनते रहें, क्वेश्चन आंसर सेशन चलता रहेगा। ये फॉर्म भरें और आपके जीमेल अकाउंट पर ये आपको ई सर्टिफिकेट ऑटोमेटिक जनरेट होकर आपको मिलेगा। तो कृपया ये फॉर्म भरें सभी। और एक बात और कि इसको एक ही बार भरें, दो बार भरने पे ये एक ही बार काम करेगा, तो इस बात का भी ध्यान रखें। प्रश्न मैं लेता हूं अब। प्रश्न संतोष कुमार जी ने पूछा है कि इफ समवन इज फ्रॉम बिहार वेयर ही और शी विल फाइल पेटेंट एप्लीकेशन। मैं डॉक्टर विनीता मैडम से आग्रह करूंगा कि कृपया इसका जवाब दें। प्रश्न है इफ समवन इज फ्रॉम बिहार वेयर ही और शी विल फाइल पेटेंट एप्लीकेशन। डॉक्टर विनीता मैडम, मैं डॉक्टर सिन्हा सर से रिक्वेस्ट करूंगा।
यह डॉक्टर गौतम।
अच्छा अच्छा सॉरी सॉरी मैम, प्लीज प्लीज, एक प्रश्न है संतोष जी का।
या आई हाँ, ये मैंने आपका प्रश्न सुना, ये इनको कोलकाता में फाइल करना पड़ेगा। अगर आपने उस स्लाइड पे ध्यान दिया हो तो जो ज्यूरिसडिक्शंस या जो स्टेट्स कहीं पर भी कवर नहीं हुई हैं, उनको कोलकाता में अप्लाई करना है पेटेंट एप्लीकेशन।
बहुत बहुत अच्छे, मैं समझता हूँ संतोष कुमार जी का प्रश्न का उत्तर उन्हें मिल गया है। दूसरा प्रश्न मैं लेता हूँ मैम, जो डॉक्टर सुशील कुमार है, सुशील कुमार उपाध्याय जी, मैम ये पूछना चाहते हैं व्हाट इज द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ पब्लिश्ड पेटेंट टू अवार्डेड पेटेंट।
So, जैसा कि आपने प्रोसेस में देखा कि देयर इज अ स्टेप वाइज प्रोसेस, इफ इट इज पब्लिश्ड बाय द पेटेंट ऑफिस एज अ पेटेंट इन्वेंटर और
दुगुना करेगी कितना आएगा,
1.5 को 10.5 बढ़ाना है।
हाँ तो बढ़ाइए बड़ी, 10.5 को 10.5।
मोनिका जी,
मोनिका जी को म्यूट कर दीजिएगा।
मैं आमंत्रित हैं, कृपया प्रश्न पूछें सभी पार्टिसिपेंट्स, जो भी अपनी क्वेरी है वो पूछ सकते हैं, चैट बॉक्स में पोस्ट कर सकते हैं। डॉक्टर सिन्हा सर से कोई प्रश्न पूछना चाहते हैं, सभी पार्टिसिपेंट से आग्रह है आप अपना प्रश्न रख सकते हैं।
गौतम जी तो मैं सीधे प्रश्न पूछ लूं एक।
सर प्लीज सर।
मैडम विनीता जी,
हम जी सर,
मैं जानना चाह रहा था कई बार क्या होता है हम रिसर्च पेपर पब्लिश कर देते हैं।
हाँ जी सर।
जो आपने बताया थोड़ा जल्दी रहता है स्टूडेंट्स को, कोई नया काम हम करते हैं अच्छा होता है, आइडिया भी अच्छा होता है, बट उसको हम कहीं ना कहीं जर्नल्स में जस्ट टू गेट द इमीडिएट बेनिफिट ऑफ दैट उसको पब्लिश कर लेते हैं। उसके बाद हम लोग की समझ में आता है कि नहीं ये काम तो बड़ा अच्छा है और इस पे तो पेटेंट हो सकता था, तो क्या पॉसिबिलिटी है कि ऐसे जो पब्लिश माने आइडियाज हैं उनको भी पेटेंटिंग में लिया जा सकता है, इस पे आप थोड़ा बता सकते हैं?
जैसा कि मैंने आपको बताया कि प्रायर आर्ट जब हम सर्च करते हैं तो उसमें हम वो आर्टिकल्स भी देखते हैं कि जो पहले ही डिस्क्लोज कर दिए गए हैं या किसी जर्नल में पब्लिश हो गए हैं। तो अगर मैंने अपना ही पेपर पब्लिश कर दिया है तो कभी कभी ऐसा हो जाता है कि विद इन अ ईयर या विद इन अ मंथ अगर मैं उसको फाइल कर देती हूँ पेटेंट एप्लीकेशन, वो पेटेंट ऑफिस के उसमें जाता है, वो हमेशा क्या करेंगे कि जब भी वो पेटेंट सर्च करेंगे वो आपका डॉक्यूमेंट उसमें साइट कर देंगे और उसमें यही बोलेंगे कि ये आपने पेटेंट फाइल करने से पहले सबमिट कर दिया था कहीं पब्लिकेशन के लिए। तो क्योंकि जब हम बहुत स्ट्रिक्ट क्राइटेरिया फॉलो करते हैं नॉवल्टी के लिए तो उसमें बहुत मुश्किल हो जाता है कि आप पेटेंट फाइल कर सके। हम हमेशा अपने यहाँ पर ये सलाह देते हैं कि आप पब्लिश करना चाहते हैं, क्योंकि हमारे यहाँ भी साइंटिस्ट लोग यहाँ से फंड लेते हैं, तो हम उनको हमेशा ये बोलते हैं कि आप थोड़ा वेट कीजिए। अगर आपको लगता है कि आप पेटेंट फाइल करना चाहते हैं तो पहले पेटेंट फाइल कीजिए, उसके बाद आप पब्लिकेशन में जाइए, क्योंकि एक बार अगर पब्लिश हो गया तो फिर बहुत ही मुश्किल है कि आपको उसके लिए पेटेंट फाइल करने दिया जाएगा। आई मीन आप कर सकते हैं लेकिन पॉसिबिलिटी नहीं है कि आपको वो ग्रांट होगा।
थैंक यू मैडम। गौतम जी, कुछ पार्टिसिपेंट्स ने क्वेश्चंस लिखे हैं, आप लीजिएगा, अनम्यूट कर लीजिएगा प्लीज। गौतम जी अनम्यूट करके बोलिएगा।
थैंक यू सर। एक प्रश्न डॉक्टर प्रदीप कुमार जी पूछना चाहते हैं, इज देयर एनी प्रोसेस ऑफ फी वेव टू फाइल ए पेटेंट?
तो फी वेवर अवेलेबल है, वो स्टार्टअप्स के लिए है, और जैसा मैंने मेंशन किया कि डिफरेंट कैटेगरी बनी हुई है कि अगर आप लीगल एंटिटी है, यूनिवर्सिटी है, तो डिफरेंट सेट ऑफ फी फाइल करना पड़ता है, और अगर आप स्टार्टअप हैं तो उनको काफ़ी अच्छा गवर्नमेंट की तरफ से रिबेट मिल रहा है, और अगर आप नेचुरल पर्सन और इंडिविजुअल के नाम पर फाइल करते हैं तो थोड़ा सा फी में कंसेशन है, बट जो ज्यादा बेनिफिट्स हैं वो स्टार्टअप के कॉन्टेक्स्ट में है फी वेवर में।
थैंक यू मैम। और इंतजार कर रहे हैं हम प्रश्न पूछे।
गौतम जी, एक डॉक्टर आर के सिन्हा जी हमारे साथ हैं, मैं देख पा रहा हूँ अभी मीटिंग में हैं। सर से मेरा निवेदन है, आपने अपने लेक्चर में भी TSIR और यूपी स्टेट गवर्नमेंट का जो नॉलेज पार्टनर की बात की थी, क्योंकि एक अच्छा मंच है, काफ़ी पार्टिसिपेंट्स यहाँ जुड़े हैं और कई इंस्टीट्यूशंस के हेड्स भी यहाँ हैं, हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट्स हैं, तो अगर आप इस पर थोड़ा सा और हमें माने बताएं, प्रकाश डालें कि किस तरह ये संभव होगा, कैसे भविष्य में CSIR उत्तर प्रदेश सरकार का नॉलेज पार्टनर बनेगा, ऐसा कुछ बताएंगे तो मुझे लगता है कि बहुत ही बेनिफिशियल होगा, काफी लोग यहाँ जुड़े हैं, इस पे आप एक मिनट आप थोड़ा बताएं प्लीज।
या श्योर, थैंक यू प्रोफेसर सिंह। इसमें ऐसा है कि जो उत्तर प्रदेश गवर्नमेंट है वो चारों तरफ से यूपी का डेवलपमेंट चाहते हैं, और उसको डेवलप करने में नेचुरली साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी का काफ़ी बहुत बड़ा एक रोल रहता है। तो व्हाट वी हैव डिसाइडेड दैट वी हैव द फोर लैब्स व्हिच इज सिचुएटेड इन लखनऊ, दैट आर प्राइमरीली बायो साइंसेज लैब, बट CSIR के साथ जब हम नॉलेज पार्टनर में जाएंगे तो CSIR, जैसे मैंने अपने मैप में दिखाया था कि हमारे 37 लैब्स हैं और पूरे ही इंडिया में फैले हुए हैं, एंड दो सब्जेक्ट्स जो हैं वो हम लोग डिफेंस और एटॉमिक एनर्जी, इन दो चीज़ को अगर आप छोड़ दें और न्यूक्लियर को छोड़ दें तो ऑलमोस्ट इन एवरी फील्ड वी आर। तो जो यूपी के यूनिवर्सिटीज़ हैं, एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूट्स जो हैं, अगर आप हमारे लैब के साथ पार्टनर करना चाहते हैं, R&D collaborative projects के लिए, तो यू कैन गो, यू कैन जस्ट चूज योर, जैसे फिजिक्स है, आप फिजिक्स डिपार्टमेंट में मटेरियल साइंस में अगर आप काम कर रहे हैं तो जो हमारा लैब है भोपाल में एम्प्री है, एडवांस मटेरियल प्रोसेस रिसर्च इंस्टीट्यूट है, या IMT भुवनेश्वर है जो कि मिनरल्स के ऊपर काम करता है, और ग्लास एंड सेरेमिक्स है कलकत्ता में, उनका भी बेसिकली सेरेमिक्स है, मटेरियल्स उनका भी है, मटेरियल्स और भी कई सारे लैब्स हैं। फिजिक्स में अगर आप प्योरली फिजिक्स में करना चाह रहे हैं तो नेशनल फिजिकल लेबोरेटरी, एवरीबॉडी नोज अबाउट दैट, तो आप उनके डायरेक्टर से आप एक प्लान लेकर के आप डिस्कस कीजिए, वी कैन हैव द ज्वाइंट कोलैबोरेटिव रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट, दैट इज वन। दूसरा ये है कि हम लोग अभी स्कीम पे वो वर्क कर रहे हैं, अभी उसमें थोड़ा सा टाइम लगेगा, जिसमें कि वी आर ट्राइंग टू हैव द मोबिलिटी ऑफ द साइंटिस्ट बोथ वे, मीन्स कि हमारे साइंटिस्ट जो हैं वो कुछ दिन के लिए आपके यूनिवर्सिटी में जाकर के कुछ टीचिंग का काम करेंगे, और वाइस वर्सा आपके जो असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर हैं, प्रोफेसर हैं या एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर हैं, उनका भी हम लोग एक वेन्यू देख रहे हैं कि फॉर सम टाइम, फॉर 3 months, 6 months, 1 year, दे कैन कम टू एनी CSIR लैब एंड दे कैन वर्क एज ए साइंटिस्ट। तो वो उसमें भी टाइम लगेगा, उसके बारे में ज्यादा नहीं अभी कमेंट करूंगा मैं, लेकिन ज्वाइंट रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट्स जो हैं वो आप MOU इंडिविजुअल लैब के साथ कर सकते हैं। जैसे फॉर एग्जांपल मैं बताऊं आपको, जो एम्प्री है हमारा भोपाल में, इन्होंने कुछ दिन पहले जो आपकी जो राम मनोहर लोहिया अवध यूनिवर्सिटी है अयोध्या में, उनके साथ उन्होंने एक MOU किया हुआ है। उसमें क्या होता है कि आपके यहाँ के जो रिसर्च स्टूडेंट्स हैं, अगर उनको किसी इक्विपमेंट की जरूरत है तो दे कैन कम टू आवर लैब एज पर दिस MOU, वहाँ पे आप आइए, हम आपको जो भी लोकल हॉस्पिटैलिटी है वो प्रोवाइड करेंगे, एंड यू कैन यूटिलाइज आवर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर देयर। जैसे मैंने अपने स्लाइड में दिखाया था कि CSIR जैसे लैब्स के पास इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर की कमी नहीं है, इक्विपमेंट्स सब के पास हमारे पास कमी नहीं है, तो आप डायरेक्टली लैब से बात करके आप जो आपके रिसर्च से रिलेटेड जो भी आपके वर्क हैं वो हमारे यहाँ आप कर सकते हैं अंडर दैट MOU। उसके अलावा एक और एवेन्यू है जो कि अभी हम लोग कुछ दिन में उसको हम लोग अभी पब्लिक के लिए ओपन करेंगे, जितने भी मेजर इक्विपमेंट्स हैं CSIR लैब्स में, दे हैव ऑल कम टुगेदर इन वन प्लेटफॉर्म, और उसमें आप ऑनलाइन बुकिंग करके अपना एक्सपेरिमेंट्स कर सकते हैं, एंड स्टूडेंट्स के लिए, एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूट्स के लिए फीस काफ़ी कम है, लेकिन वो अभी हम लोग अभी विद इन CSIR कर रहे हैं, आउटसाइड CSIR अभी हम लोगों ने किया नहीं है। एंड आपको जानकारी के लिए बताऊं कि जो प्रिंसिपल साइंटिफिक एडवाइजर हैं गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया, प्रोफेसर विजय राघव जी, उनके ऑफिस ने इनफैक्ट CSIR को हटा करके, CSIR उसमें शामिल नहीं है, बाकी जितने भी एकेडमिक जो R&D इंस्टीट्यूट्स हैं वहाँ के इक्विपमेंट को ऑलरेडी उन्होंने क्लब किया हुआ है,
आई स्टेम
या आप जानते हैं उसके बारे में। तो हम लोग जो वैसे CSIR का CSIR का अपना सिस्टम है, और वो हम लोग उनके साथ PSA के साथ अटैच हो जाएंगे, तो यू कैन यूटिलाइज दैट ऑल्सो। तो वो तो बात की बात है, बट अगर अभी आपको कोई चीज करना है तो आप सिंपली जो भी आपके जो प्रोबेबल लैब हैं उनके साथ डायरेक्टर साथ MOU कीजिए, उसमें वहाँ के जो साइंटिस्ट हैं वो आपके यहाँ आकर के आपके एक्सपेरिमेंट्स को सुपरवाइज भी कर सकते हैं, लेक्चर दे सकते हैं, आपके यहाँ के जो रिसर्च स्कॉलर्स हैं, फैकल्टी हैं, दे कैन गो टू दैट लैब और वो उनके डिस्कशन कर सकते हैं, साइंटिफिक डिस्कशंस हैं, कॉन्फ्रेंसेस ऑर्गेनाइज कर सकते हैं साथ में। और फ्रॉम HRDC पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू हम लोग उसमें ये इंक्लूड कर रहे हैं कि आपके लिए, क्योंकि HRDC जो है ये बहुत सारे प्रोग्राम्स ऑर्गेनाइज करता है, बट मेजर प्रोग्राम्स जो है हमारे CSIR के लोगों के लिए हम लोग करते हैं, कुछ प्रोग्राम्स हैं जो CSIR के बाहर भी करते हैं। सो अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम, ये जो नॉलेज पार्टनरशिप वाला है, इसमें हम लोग एकेडमिक इंस्टीट्यूट्स के फैकल्टीज को, स्टूडेंट्स को डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ हम लोग आपको प्लेटफॉर्म देंगे, जैसे लीडरशिप प्रोग्राम है, बिहेवियरल साइंस है, साइंस के हैं, जैसे अभी हम लोगों ने कुछ दिन पहले आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस इन R&D पे काम एक वेबिनार कराया था, एंड मोर देन 300 पीपल फ्रॉम अक्रॉस CSIR हैव जॉइंड एंड इस वाज अ होल डे प्रोग्राम। तो इस टाइप का जब हमारे पास आपके साथ जब नॉलेज पार्टनर आप हमारे हो जाएंगे तो हम लोग आपको लिंक भेजेंगे एंड यू कैन ऑल्सो बेनिफिटेड फ्रॉम दोज काइंड ऑफ प्रोग्राम्स। सो दीज आर द बेसिक थिंग्स, बट बेसिकली दिस इज एन अम्ब्रेला MOU बिटवीन UP गवर्नमेंट एंड द CSIR, एंड देन उसके बीच में फिर आप जिस पर्टिकुलर लैब के साथ करना चाहते हैं तो इंडिविजुअली अंडर दैट अम्ब्रेला यू कैन हैव एन MOU। सो आई थिंक आई एम एबल टू सैटिस्फाई योर क्वेरी।
थैंक यू सर। यहां मैं 1 मिनट गौतम जी लूंगा। प्रोफेसर Y विमला जी हैं, हमारी प्रोवाइस चांसलर हैं, और मैडम और मैं स्वयं भी, मेरा ज़्यादा योगदान नहीं रहता, ऑल्दो हमारी नेशनल एजुकेशन पॉलिसी को देख रही हैं कैसे UP स्टेट में उसका क्रियान्वयन होना है और रिसर्च किस तरह होगी, वहाँ भी मैडम के अच्छे सुझाव रहते हैं। तो निश्चित ही मुझे लगता है कि मैडम के लिए भी एक नई बात, नया माने राष्ट्रीय शिक्षा नीति में जोड़ने के लिए एक पॉइंट या एक नई डायरेक्शन भी हम लोग को मिली होगी। साथ साथ आइंस्टाइन की जो आपने बात की, यहाँ मैं ये भी मेंशन कर दूं कि हमारे यहाँ से हमारे ही साथी हैं डिपार्टमेंट के, हमारे एलुमनस हैं डॉक्टर उपदेश वर्मा जी, गवर्नमेंट डिग्री कॉलेज में प्राध्यापक हैं, आप उसके नोडल ऑफिसर हैं, तो वो भी इस पे आगे अपना काम बढ़ाएंगे, माने हमारे यूनिवर्सिटीज या आसपास का जो भी इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर है उसको आइंस्टाइन में लाके एक उस पोर्टल पे ये फैसिलिटीज आएंगी, ऐसा माने इस वेबिनार के माध्यम से भी हम सुनिश्चित कर सकते हैं। अब मैं आगे कार्रवाई के लिए पुनः अपने साथी योगेंद्र गौतम जी से निवेदन करूंगा कि वो प्रश्न उत्तर का समय अब समाप्त ही मान लें, आगे मैडम को इनवाइट करें और आगे की प्रोसीडिंग शुरू करें।
प्रोफेसर वीरपाल सर के लिए बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण प्रश्न आपने पूछा और डॉक्टर सिन्हा सर ने उसी के संदर्भ में बहुत उपयोगी बातें हमें बताई। इफ देयर इज नो क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम अवर पार्टिसिपेंट, देन आई रिक्वेस्ट टू अवर प्रो चांसलर मैडम, वाइस चांसलर मैडम प्रोफेसर वाई विमला फॉर अ प्रेसिडेंशियल एड्रेस। सो बिफोर द एड्रेस लेट मी गिव ब्रीफ इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट मैडम। प्रोफेसर वाई विमला is a professor of botany department and she is a great researcher and botanist. She has published about 60 peer-reviewed journal publications and she guided 55 MPhil project thesis and 28 students have been completed their PhD under her supervision. And madam wrote many book and book chapters and she has awarded many fellowship and honor from India as well as abroad. So, and special things, she is a great speaker. I personally like in bilingual speech in English as well as Hindi. So, सबसे बड़ी बात मैडम मैं ये है कि she never get tensed. मैडम बहुत सारी responsibility विश्वविद्यालय की करती रही हैं और कभी मैंने tense नहीं देखी हैं। और जब जब हमको कोई प्रॉब्लम आती है हम मैडम के पास जाते हैं और मैडम उसका जो सॉल्यूशन है बहुत जल्दी कर देती हैं। जैसे कल बताएं कि प्रोफेसर वीरपाल सर ने हमें बताया कि कुछ ऑफिस में अर्जेंट मीटिंग सिन्हा सर की थी तो कुछ श्योरिटी नहीं हो रही थी लेक्चर की, देन वी वेंट टू मैडम और मैडम ने फिर सारे प्रयास अपने हमारे सॉल्यूशन में लगा दिए और फाइनली हमें एक बहुत अच्छी स्पीकर जिन्होंने आज बहुत नॉलेजेबल इंफॉर्मेटिव लेक्चर दिया, डॉक्टर विनीता जिंदल जो मैडम के द्वारा हमें प्राप्त हुई, उसके लिए भी मैडम को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। तो वैसे तो मैडम का परिचय देने में बहुत मतलब मैं समझता हूँ कि लगभग 30-35 पेजेस का अगर मैं बायोडाटा पढ़ूँ दिस विल टेक लॉट टाइम, आई थिंक आई कांट कवर इन माई वर्ड्स एक्चुअली द इंट्रोडक्शन ऑफ अवर पीवीसी मैडम। So I request Professor Madam, please deliver your presidential address. Thank you, ma'am. Please.
Thank you very much, Dr. Yogendra Gautam ji. Present over here, Professor Vipal, Dr. R.K. Sinha ji, Dr. Vinita Jindal, Dr. Anuj Kumar, Dr. Anil Yadav, Dr. Rupdesh Verma, Dr. Kavita and many other of our friends and colleagues who are here along with the students. I am sure that this webinar was of special requirement for them and Dr. Birpal had rightly thought about conducting a webinar on intellectual property rights. However, in our research methodology courses also, we have terms like plagiarism, copyright, in copyright infringement on all others, but we are not talking about patents to the extent they should be included. And this is where the students lag. They don't have any motivation, no understanding about how to go in for a patent. So today's both lectures were great as they were very informative and very simple in language and expression. So I'm sure that all the students and my colleagues, they all might have been benefited by such lecture. Now I'm sure that they will also develop ties, MOU with CSIR, and which is very possible. In our new PhD regulation also, we have given scope to MOUs. And those who are coming under MOUs with us, they can become supervisors or co-supervisors as well. So this is how we can increase our scope, widen the horizon, and students will also be getting the advantage of research knowledge of various fields, the equipment and other potential things which they need, they can avail if the MOUs materialize. Besides that, in NEP also, Dr. Birpal Singh is also with us in the steering committee, and we all are trying to find out ways to implement NEP 2020, which is a very ambitious document. Implementation is not going to be easy at all. However, we are putting all our efforts so that multidisciplinary approach, openness, according to need, according to taste, interest, the students can take up different courses and can come up with research aptitude and attitude, both. So all this at the end is based on our knowledge of whether we are going to publish or perish, whether we are going to patent or let things be only published or not even being published. So earlier the students didn't know anything and they used to publish in any third rate journal, which is most accessible to them. But now students have also become aware and they don't try to publish their work in any second rate journal. They would always like to publish it at least in the matching journal to the level of their work they have done. Now, if they understand about patent, because novelty is there in the soul of Uttar Pradesh, they are very innovative people. You can, those who can develop, those who can find out jugaad can do anything. So these people have the innovations in their mind and soul. If given a chance, they can patent n number of things, processes and materials both. So this kind of MOUs and this kind of knowledge will certainly make them more self-reliant and developing several patents to their name. So I think I must thank both the speakers because they have shared their knowledge very openly, very nicely, in a way that we all can understand, can follow, and tomorrow we all will be benefited. And to add to this, Vinita was my student during PhD. I don't want to say a few things, but I know the day she joined after PhD IPR, I was sure that she is going to come up with flying colors. She has left behind her PhD work and she has gone into another realm. There was a paradigm shift in her personality and work, the confidence that she gained. So I'm very happy about her. She earlier also, she has given in an FGP this lecture regarding patents, and people, that group of people who attended that, they were also very much benefited. Dr. R.K. Sinha, because I don't have to say words, he has himself proved out to be a wonderful person with all the knowledge which is being shared. And he has also proposed to become knowledge partners with the universities, which is still not there, but this will be possible soon. Because CSIR also has its own university now, yet because of NEP, now there will be more and more university social responsibilities or corporate responsibilities which will be involved in all these universities. And hence, we will develop better ties, better understanding, and share the knowledge. We were also, Dr. Birpal would also agree to it, that we have shared that there must be a knowledge portal where we must know that in which university, which kind of knowledge partners are available, what is the expertise people have, and what are the kinds of working equipment they have, and how much can they allow us to work. So if a common portal will be developed for India itself, there will be several such exchanges and MOUs shortly coming up. So NEP is going to give way to one India and the best India. So thank you very much for organizing this webinar and inviting me here to be a part of it. Thank you very much. Along with both the speakers, I'm thanking. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, madam, for your inspiring words and motivation. And we should learn a lot from you. After the bad health, you address the presidential address. Thank you so much, ma'am. for supporting us, for joining us. Now for vote of thanks, officially vote of thanks, I request Dr. Anil Kumar Yadav for vote of thanks. Dr. Yadav, sir.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. Respected Professor Y. Bimla, Pro Vice Chancellor of this university, respected speakers, Dr. R. K. Sinha and Dr. Vinita Jindal. Our first speaker, Dr. R. K. Sinha, head CSIR HRDC Ghaziabad, who nicely explained about intellectual property rights with examples and give the message how can convert our idea in wealth or my to market. He also mentioned that CSIR and UP government have signed a AMU, and our university also wish to join this AMU in future. And our second speaker, Dr. Vinita Jindal, Chief Manager, IP and Technology Management Research Assistant Council, DIRC, who speaks in details about filling the process of patent. We thank both speakers for gracing today's webinar and speaks on the topic and intellectual property rights rewards to investors. We are deeply grateful to the Professor N.K. Taneja, Honorable Vice Chancellor of this university and patron of this webinar, for providing the permission and e-platform to conduct this event. I would like thanks to Professor Y. Bimla Madam for gracing today's webinar by their presence. My heartfelt thanks to all Dean of Faculty of various departments of university and college for their valuable guidance and encouragement in all our effort. I also wish to express my gratitude to our organizing committee members, mainly convener Professor Bipal Singh, who take initiative to conduct this webinar on this important topic, and organizing secretary Dr. YK Gautam, who make all the effort to invite speaker and participants. I would also like to thanks to Professor Anil Malik, Professor Anush Kumar, Professor Sanjeev Kumar Sharma, Dr. Kavita Sharma, and for their contribution, who support smoothly to conducting this webinar. I am also giving my big thanks to Dr. Shobhna Chaudhary, scientist at CSIR Ghaziabad, who introduced today's speaker, Dr. R.K. Sinha, and convinced him to deliver today's talk. I also thanks to Dr. Ubesh Verma for their technical support to conducting this webinar. I also thank to faculty member of this university, Professor Ashok Chobe, Professor Lohani, Professor S.S. Gauro, Professor Sudhir Kumar Sharma, Professor Jamal Siddiqui, Professor Vijay Jaiswal, Dr. G.S. Rahul, and others whom I am not mentioned here, and other university faculty, Professor Ashok Sharma, Kajan, and other faculties whose presence graced this webinar. I must mention our deep sense of appreciation to our PhD students, basically PhD, MPhil, MSc, from our university and from other university and colleges who actively participate and calmly listen to the speakers. Thanks to all. And finally, I want to quote mention a quote of Dr. A.P.A. Abdul Kalam, thinking should become your capital asset no matter whatever ups and downs you come across in your life. So, and finally, I want to say once again, thank you all for your attention. Thank you.
So, Dr. Anil Yadav ji, now I hand over to our respected head of the department, Professor V. Pal sir.
No, it's okay. Thanks to all. Now, with the kind permission, we may close the session. We may close the meeting with the kind permission of our Pro Vice Chancellor Madam. So this would close. Thanks to all and good day to all.
Thank you sir.
ये feedback link अभी जो है ये open है, तो अगर किसी ने feedback नहीं भरा है तो आप भर दीजिए, क्योंकि इसके बाद फिर certificate नहीं मिल पाएंगे किसी को भी। वैसे
मैं सर एक बात और और शेयर कर रहा हूँ, एक बार और मैंने शेयर कर दिया है फीडबैक, तो जिनका नहीं भरा है वो फिल कर सकते हैं।
हाँ, वैसे करीब 75 लोग ऑलरेडी कर चुके हैं फीडबैक अपना सबमिट और सर्टिफिकेट ले चुके हैं, तो मे बी कुछ लोग ही बचे होंगे।
गुड गुड थैंक यू, थैंक यू सर,
गुड सर,
ठीक है,
थैंक यू सर। Should we wait 5 minutes for a feedback form? Okay, sir.
Maybe.
भरना है, भर लिया होगा.
Okay, okay, sir. Thank you. Okay. Now we can leave. Thank you, sir.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you very much. बंद तो हो गया ना? Post. लेकिन मेरे बंद करते ही वो हो जाएंगे, मैं देख करूंगा। तो क्या वायरल मैडम के हॉस्पिटल, चलो मैं देख।